Who did?
Ever.
Why did you pay?
That one's on me.
All right.
I didn't pay for yesterday, did I?
No.
When I thought L.A. called me the N-word?
Right.
All right, hold on. I got a dollar. Yeah. There.
All right.
Here. Take another one for later.
Building up credit, I like that.
Yeah. Works forever, and I may try it.
Yeah, it's not a bad way to go.
Did you hear anything from yesterday?
No, not a thing.
Finally got a hold of L.A.
Yeah.
You can pull that mic. Will that mic boom not come all the way to your face?
There. How's that?
You just always look so uncomfortable.
No, I'm fine. I'm just in a suit, and I've been running around all day.
Okay.
But I'm fine.
All right. Hold on a second. What are we going to call this guy screening the phone? Do what?
O'Malley.
All right. I don't want to call him O'Malley.
Right. Make up a name for him.
I'll just call him Danny. How about that? Is that a retarded chick on line 10? No? Why does it say Special Olympics? All right. Hello?
Hi.
Yes, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm fine. What can I do for you?
Well, we came up with a name. We thought we'd call O'Malley, just call him the Big O.
No. No, we don't do nicknames around here.
We are hoping you'll help us, Russ.
With what?
Well, the Special Olympics is going to be doing a black tie gala here in Dallas to benefit our special athletes. And we want to get some corporate sponsors, and we want to get some of the attendees and donation items to our gala.
So what were you wanting from me? This is, you want, what
we
do you want?
We want your push and support. We want to be able to talk to you about this, and you just basically convince all of your loyal followers to come to this event and help us out. He's laughing.
I'm not laughing at anything. I go, what is the event?
The event is going to be at the here in Dallas, November 9th, at the Adolphus Hotel. And we're looking for corporate sponsors to possibly sponsor a table, or people can come to the event.
You mean a table with other people that are in the Special Olympics?
That, yes, and we're going to have some. We're going to be honoring our heroes.
You wanna go?
Yeah.
we're gonna be having some Mike Madonnas there and some Scott Murrays and. The head coach for the Dallas Desperados.
Now, are they actually in the Special Olympics, or are they the celebs?
They. that's a fine line, isn't it?
Yeah.
Depending on how good the season's going. They are our heroes. They've donated us.
You know, with the Special Olympics. Nobody with the Special Olympics would ever say that.
I'm just a volunteer. So.
Oh, well, you can say whatever you want then.
Well, exactly. So we're trying to make it humorous. But in all seriousness, you know, mental retardation does not discriminate against anyone. It affects people from, you know, infancy all the way up into adulthood.
Yeah, we were hoping it would just attack the Chinese.
The way they drive.
Yeah.
I listen to your show, Russ.
You can tell she's not paid for the Special Olympics.
Trying to find the humor.
Yeah, absolutely, because she knows. Have you worked with mentally challenged kids?
I have, and I also have some family members, and that's how I got involved.
Yeah. And you'd agree with me that these people are the most happy people. That's God's balance.
We are so undeserving to be around them.
Yeah.
We are. I know that you've talked about this plenty of times on your show. They are so loving and giving and happy and just, it's a blessing.
They don't ask for much.
They don't ask for anything.
They're, you know, they're good workers. Like I said, the Kroger that I go to, they use a lot of, mentally handicapped people. I like the fact that they do that. And I'm sure, you know, all the grocery stores, like I said before, they get a bonus too because they're employing people that normally nobody else would hire, and you can pay them with leaves.
No.
Cash.
Yeah.
Mostly cash.
Yeah, mostly cash.
At least they tell them it's cash.
Look, I don't gotta go to work today. Money, trees.
You guys are horrible.
I know it. All right, so it's November when?
We are doing it November 9th at the Adolphus Hotel.
Okay, I forget. I wasn't paying attention earlier. What do you want from me? Actually, me.
Russ, we want you to tell your listeners that we are looking for corporate sponsors to attend this event.
Okay.
Have a special. We're doing a silent live auction. We would love for people to donate any and all items that they could for the silent auction.
Do we have anything to give? Anything that's auctionable? Anything that's worth anything?
A date with you, Russ.
No. That's not worth something.
A ride in that car.
Oh, the Batmobile, buddy.
Yeah, we could do the Batmobile thing.
We smile at you.
I'm just thinking.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. I know exactly what you're thinking about. The same thing I did with the Mach 5.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Are you full? You certainly have eaten a lot of air today.
Never. No,
I'm not
we want to do this
you.
Again and again and again.
Sorry.
Is it hot in here? Because we got 6 people today.
It's warm.
Oh. Eddie, check and see if the air is all the way down.
It's hot in the whole building.
Oh, is it?
Yep. Our office is miserable.
Why?
I don't know.
Have they had the air guys out here working on this stuff?
But Russ, we were hoping we could give you contact information for people to call. And
you realize you're going to get kicked out of this organization after today, right?
I'm a volunteer, so I'm kind of already on the out.
Oh, okay.
I hope they see the humor. I really, I think I probably warned them about you.
Oh, okay. What? What's the contact?
The contact is Vanjie Garza. And she's director of development.
Mm-hmm.
She can be reached at 214.
You sure you want to give this number out?
I promise I do.
All right, go ahead.
214-943-9981.
And that's for people that want to sponsor and stuff like that?
If they want to sponsor, if they just want to attend the event, or if they'd like to donate something to our silent auction. You know, it's no secret that since 9/11, a lot of organizations such as ours have suffered with their charitable events, and we're really hoping that this event's going to pull us through here for the Texas chapter. And we were really, really counting on you, and we do appreciate you so much. Because I know your time is valuable.
Yes, it is. Very valuable.
It is.
How old are you?
I'm too old for you. I'm in my 30s.
Are you?
Yes, sir.
Are you married?
I'm taller than you.
You're taller than me?
I'm taller than you.
How tall are you?
6 foot.
I'm 6 foot.
I am? Mm-hmm. But I wear heels.
What is that noise in the background? Is that some of the kids?
No, sir.
Are they building stuff?
No. we got to talk about this event. We can't talk about me. I'm too old. I know. Now you're going to call me a fat.
I'm not saying anything. All right. Do you have a website or anything?
They can actually go to the www.specialolympics.com and go to calendar of events and pull up November 9th.
Okay.
We've got some. If people just want to contact Vanjie,
yes.
214-943-9981.
You asked for it. All right. Well, we'll dig around in our offices and see if we have anything worth auctioning.
I would appreciate that so
all
much.
Right. Well, it was very nice of you to call.
Thank you, Russ.
Then with you.
All right.
She knew what I meant there at the end.
I know.
Code.
Does she know who she's calling?
She obviously did.
She listens to the show.
I don't have any problems with retarded kids. I feel bad when anything bad happens to kids.
What is it, kids or animals?
Animals, yeah.
That was the other one.
Because normally they have no choice and something horrible didn't happen to them. Now, if you're an adult and you got cancer or your legs got chopped off or whatever, there's a really good chance you made some bad decisions in life and you got to that point. Kids and animals, they don't make those decisions. I don't mind helping the handicap. It's got to get irritating listening to that all day, though.
So what happened yesterday? You were going to tell me, and then we got the phone call. And
I want to listen to this again. Hold on a second. What is it, Ronnie?
Hey, I think the only way you should do it is if they allow you to have a boxing match against Gary right in the middle of it. Gary can represent the Special Olympics, and you can represent the Russ Martin Show. What do you think? I can hook it up. I know Gary pretty well.
You seriously know Gary?
Yeah, you got to watch out, though. He kicks. He got into a fight with my mom's best friend's husband.
Oh, so your mom.
He started slapping him and kicking him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So Gary doesn't punch.
He might if you tie his legs up.
All right, because I got the wrestling thing with Gary that's supposed to be September 1st.
Okay, well, here's a boxing match right here. You can get all the boxing gear on, let him wear a singlet. That'd be kind of funny, don't you think?
Wear a what?
a singlet, one of those little wrestling outfits that the Ultimate, or not the Ultimate, the Andre the Giant used to wear.
Oh, like Owen Hart?
Yeah, there you go.
Or dress him up, you know, some leotards with a bunch of feathers and then put
him. There you go. Let him wear it.
Yeah. And then strap him to the side of the ring, mm-hmm. one of the posts. You know those outfits that they put on kids when you put them on leashes?
Yes.
You know, so they can't get away from you?
Like a harness.
Yeah, a harness. Put him in one of those.
He'd probably do it, too.
So he can only come out like so far. Eight, you know, 6 feet from the corner.
Run away.
I like that. We may do that. Thanks, Ronnie.
The human turnbuckle.
Just so he can only come so far. That way I can push him and irritate him. And when I get tired, I can back up 6.5 feet.
Make it a bungee where if he runs at you, he bounces backwards.
I saw that on Foghorn Leghorn once.
Yeah. Always worked.
Yeah.
Take care. I don't understand this one. What is it, Bobby?
Hey, we know that you like to help a handicap. We've got proof of it.
I don't even want to hear the punchline. Anyway, so we finally got a hold of L.A.
Okay.
And it sounded like I was about to get dumped.
You're kidding me.
Danger. Oh. It's how did it start? I forget. It's the phrase
she
used.
You call me? I didn't call you back because I've been thinking about some things.
Yes.
What is that?
Really?
Absolutely.
What did she say after that, though?
Then she just said... if we do this and we become hump buddies again, I can't. What's she say?
I want to tell you how I've been feeling.
Yeah.
She wanted to express her feelings. So we all figured the big dump was coming.
It really broke my heart. And I don't want that to happen again. It was up by Russ.
Yeah.
And then she turned a corner and kind of went, so if we do this again, oh, you're back in.
Yeah. Because as soon as she said, I haven't called you because I've been doing some thinking. You always know you're about to get dumped.
Unless she's in love with you.
Yes, and I'll concede that now because the M word came up.
Yeah.
I swear to God.
It was in jest, but it doesn't matter because a woman means it when she brings it up.
Oh, yes. I told you she was in love with you, and I still maintain that you're in love with her.
No.
You're just
I like her a lot. I like hanging out with her. What I don't like is the fact that she sucks for a living.
Well, there is that.
And runs around showing everybody her clam.
You even ask her not to do that. Will you just not show your clam anymore?
You can do everything else. I just like the fact she just walks around and goes, look.
And she did, first day in the studio, man. Yeah. Clothes off, naked, all day. It was open. See? Open season.
Well... every chick has a downside.
She sucks for a living.
That's a big downside.
Not just one or two, a lot.
Yeah.
And not just,
well,
the tip end, all of it.
She only did two last week.
Yeah, and she said one of them wasn't even any good.
Yeah. But this is just because you stop doesn't mean it's all gone. And can you really stop? It's not like you get on a
there's another dollar.
Can you say Dick-a-troll?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll let that one go.
Yeah.
Okay. But you can't get on a penis patch and wean yourself off of this.
Well, she might be able to. I mean, if she's truly in love with you.
She acts like she doesn't really get into it. She says a lot of times it's pain. But just the fact that you walk around showing people your goods, every port, everyone.
Well, that's just what she's grown accustomed to. You know, some people eat eggs every morning for breakfast. She?
Yeah, but they don't eat them right out of the chicken's ass. I don't know what the pertinence is there, but it's a nice visual.
Gotta be, yeah. It's pretty funny.
She did ask if you would be willing to take care of her and let her live in the house.
Nah, she was trying to make a point of, if I stop doing all this stuff, are you going to take care of me?
Right.
Which I'm not going to do.
All kidding aside, I think the two of you are the perfect couple, and here's why.
Okay.
She has problems finding suitable people to be in relationships with because of what she does for a living.
Right.
That,
which is fucking. Thank you.
But the same can be said about you, Russ.
I don't suck for a living.
No.
I am one.
But your job makes it very difficult for you to maintain a serious, long-term, committed relationship with a single woman. So you share that in common with L.A.
And I'm going to have that same problem with her.
As she is with you. That's all the more reason why the two of you should try and make it work.
She's not going to have as big a problem with girls coming up here and showing their cans and doing all that stuff as
right.
any other chick would. She won't.
All I'm saying is that the two of you have...
No, because she brought that up. She goes, "All if I stop my stuff, right. then you got to stop all of your stuff. And I'm not going to be in a relationship with somebody that sucks for a living."
What if she were to stop?
Well, she brought that up. I think what she said, she was going to do it for another year.
Another year. And then she's all yours.
And she's already throwing around the M word.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
The first one's always that little joke. When we get married.
Oh, you'll let me drive the Batmobile when we're married.
Yeah.
Is that what she said?
Absolutely.
You got really excited about the car.
L.A. Le Martin.
She said a couple other things that made me shy away from this. Because it's like, okay, you come into town a couple times a year. We'll see each other then. We'll do the bumping thing, and that'll be it.
What's Russ's biggest deal on the weekend? What's he like to do on the weekends? Tell me.
Sit at home, do nothing.
What did you want him to do? I want to go out. I want to see things. I don't want to just sit around the house. I want to go to clubs and places.
Take me places. I like sitting around, but I like going and doing stuff. See, she's already, we're not even dating. Hold on, what does this chick want? Yeah, Jill?
Hey, what's up?
Yeah?
Don't do the M word, first of all.
I don't intend to.
That's ridiculous.
Okay.
But anyway, I just want to tell you.
Okay. So this whole changing thing, and she kind of tried that the last time she was here.
Right. The furniture wasn't right.
She didn't say anything about the furniture.
I thought she wanted to move things around, or the color didn't match this. Or
she made just a couple of decorating, you know, things. She didn't say a whole lot, but she took me to buy shirts. Told me I, the car I was driving. She goes, "This car don't fit you, Dad. You need to be driving, you know." She didn't say what kind, but, you know, she meant something more like a Corvette or a whatever.
Right.
Just those things. And now take me places. I don't like that. Yeah, Daniel?
Man, you will never find a woman that will be more honest about her past sexual experiences. I mean, they're on tape. What are you going to do, lie about them?
Yeah, and?
Well, I'm just saying, you won't find that with any other woman.
But I'm not big into chicks that are exhibitionists, and that's what she is. I don't even, when we went to dinner, I specifically told her, don't wear no whore clothes out of the house. I don't want nobody looking at it, because you know she'll wear stuff with her nipples hanging out all over the place.
Yeah.
But didn't she say she'd give all that up for you?
I don't think she ever said she'd give it up.
Well, that she was, well.
Did she?
Well, maybe,
she just said she was going to stop on her own as soon as she made enough money to support herself. She didn't want to depend on anybody, which I like.
Well, I could understand how it would be weird, but, I mean, just think about it. She's honest. She tells you what she thinks, even though it might be ding-dongy sometimes.
Yeah.
Anyways, man, that's just a suggestion.
All right, I appreciate it. Thank
sure.
you. Break, Eddie?
Please.
Are you all right from yesterday?
Yeah, just a little wore out. It was a long trip.
Yeah, you look tired. I hate to ask, but how was the funeral?
We went in the wrong funeral. The funeral. We sat there for 10 minutes, trying to figure out why nobody was there.
Grandma's got a mustache. Never had before.
Hey, Meemaw's Negro.
The mustache was the tip. We didn't look in the casket. It's like laying up there. And we walked in and sat down in the pews. And we're sitting there, and I'm like going, it started at 5, and there's nobody here. Why is nobody here? We could hear people out in the hall. And so finally, my wife got up and walked out in the hall, and she goes, I think those are your relatives out there. And I got up and looked in the casket, and it was an old man. I was like, oops, hey.
I haven't seen Meemaw in a long time. She turned into a Jewish old man. Feeling all right, though?
Yeah, it's kind of weird, but I'm okay.
I don't like it when my grandparents died. I think I was like 14. I gotta go to the bathroom. I'm working on a sticker dupe. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's like I've been eating grass burrs.
Yeah.
Why does that happen?
You got something sticking in there.
Yeah.
I mean, you ever, you have one of those and you feel it baking?
Yeah.
And then you go potty and you look at it and you expect to see, you know, steel spikes sticking out of it.
Like a nutty buddy.
Yeah, you've been, you've been eating nuts the last few days. You might have one that didn't quite.
Got hung.
Didn't, you know.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Because it feels like stickers.
Yeah.
Grass burrs.
Mm-hmm. Look at them. Get them
sent. I don't want to.
Sometimes you can pass a whole nut.
It's just like corn.
Why would you say that, Eric? You ever passed a whole nut?
Yeah.
When?
A filbert back in 86.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up on the talk that rocks Texas. The new 105.3 FM Talk.
You just swallowed it?
Well, yeah, you know, sometimes you got a big old handful of nuts and a filbert gets by you.
Call us now at 214-787-1053.
Hold on a second. I'm going to get to the break, the musical break. I love this song.
What album is this? Do you remember?
Oh.
Summer something? Hold on. Endless Summer?
Yeah, I think so. People are always asking who it is. I mean,
that's Gary Hoey.
H-O-E-Y.
How are they spelling?
I don't know. People try to get all sorts of weird spelling. I get calls and emails from people that can't spell your name.
They don't deserve to know it.
I can't seem to get on Russ's website.
Yeah, Fred?
Russ, your conversation there just before the break kind of reminded me. Maybe you could fill Everett in on the origins of that little term of endearment that she used with you yesterday.
Don't you suck.
What's the story, bro?
I don't know. That was a new pet name that I've never heard her use before.
Uh-huh. Well, it would seem to rather appropriate.
Have to go.
What's your new pet name?
I don't have a pet name.
Sounds to me like you do.
Who wants to lose their job?
I don't remember.
Not a word from me.
So you're just going to leave me in the dark. That leaves you. You can tell me.
Butt nut.
She called him butt nut.
I don't even know what that means.
I almost passed out.
That was her parting shot. I was like, okay, good night, butt nut.
No. She goes, you mad little butt nut there. I don't recall her ever using that before.
True love.
It was minutes till we all could breathe again.
I shall savor it myself.
Good. Now that she's made all these demands, I don't know if I want her to come in next month.
Just have her come in for a few days. Enjoy it. And then it doesn't happen again, it doesn't happen.
And we're not even off that week, so I'm going to be gone during the day.
She can sit around smoking your office and spill stuff on your new carpet.
Oh, no the hell she's not. That's right, all my new carpet will be in by then.
Uh-huh.
Maybe she just come like Wednesday through Sunday. Got a whole week.
You're not going to see her all day, so it's not like it's a whole week. You'll just be seeing her in the evening.
Yeah, but when I get home during the week, I'm tired. I don't want to go anywhere. Because I get up at 7 or 8 in the morning, and I start reading and watching and doing stuff all the way until we get off the air at 7. When I get home, I don't want to do anything. I just want to sit.
She'll be working that weekend night, so you won't have to take her anywhere, because you obviously can't go out the nights that we work, and you can't go out Friday and Saturday, because she'll be working.
Yeah, but she's going to bitch and moan when I get home. I feel like I'm married already, and she's not even in the house.
No, I'm sure that she'll understand. She'll take into account your hard work.
No, Simon, come on, take me out there. I'm all ready. I'm not wearing my whole clothes. Let's go.
Well, I think you're missing out on all the fun you're going to have. This isn't going to be totally a drag. I mean, you're going to have this beautiful woman who loves you.
Yeah.
Wants to marry you.
Yeah.
Come stay with you and
do your laundry, clean your house, cook for you.
I don't think she ever cooked.
If she didn't know.
I think I did all the cooking.
There's a lot of good in that.
Of course, she will want me to her nasty.
Yeah.
Repeatedly. That's good, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. With those strong muscles.
Oh, yeah.
And they are.
There we are. He's back.
Excellent.
All right.
We've already gotten an email back from the Special Olympics thanking us.
What does it say?
Oh, it's just from it's from Vanjie Garza, the woman whose phone number we gave out.
Mm-hmm.
Dear Dan, Russ, JD, thank you for the opportunity to interview Cher. I guess it's your name. You guys are tough. We've already had people call to donate. They informed me that I was brave to put her on your show. Thank you, fellas. Vanjie. Just a little thank you.
Just because we make fun of retarded people doesn't mean we don't care about them.
I can see it in your eyes, just don't.
All right, grab this, we'll do news. Go ahead, JR.
Yeah, I just wondered, did anybody have Joshua Evans on our Deadpool?
Who is that?
He's an actor. It's like a little 20-year-old who was on soap opera.
Oh, yeah, he died yesterday.
Right.
Nah, nobody had him.
Oh, well, all right.
I didn't even know who that was. I saw his picture, and they were making a big deal about it on the news. Well, he died. He was 20. He had heart problems. He was some kind of midget guy. That's all I knew.
Oh, okay. I know who they're talking about.
Well, who is it?
Well, just he was up on the – I saw him on something about him on TV last night. I wasn't even paying attention to it.
I saw that, too. Who is he?
Soap just actor. An actor.
Soap actor.
He's done a bunch of movies and stuff, but nobody that we – not a major star. Nobody would really notice.
Damn, he'd have been a good one to have. He'd be worth, what, 80 points?
Yeah.
That's enough to win the Deadpool for the whole year.
Pretty much. Eddie's still in the lead.
How many points does Eddie have?
Let me pull it up here. Eddie has 46 points.
Damn, who died?
He had John Gotti die and Milton Berle die. Milton Berle was only worth 7 points.
What about Gotti?
John Gotti got him 39 points. I've got 34. JD has 17. You have none.
Crap. Who's on my list?
Tom Laughlin.
Yeah, he's got some kind of rotten cancer, right?
Yeah, he should go anytime. And B. Davis.
Tom Laughlin would be good because he's not but 60, 65, something like that, isn't he?
Net you some good points.
Yeah.
Milton Berle. I'm sorry. Hold on. The wrong list. Tom Laughlin, Ann Davis, Buddy Ebsen, Rose Marie, Boris Yeltsin, Johnny Paycheck, Faye Ray, Julia Childs, Eddie Albert, Lee Iacocca, Jonathan Harris, Cowboy Weaver, Whitney Houston.
Do we even know if Cowboy Weaver's alive? Because if he's dead, I should get those points.
No, he's still alive.
How do you know?
Because people were calling in and I looked him up. He's still alive on the Who's Who and all that. All the websites that keep track of who's dying.
Oh.
He's still kicking.
Living comfortably on the Sunset Ranch?
I don't know.
Pals of the Saddle on the Sunset Ranch.
Oh, okay.
Cowboy Weaver.
Well, okay. Was never a Cowboy Weaver.
Oh, my dad was. Crap was on every Saturday. Channel 11 had great big country programming from like 10 a.m. until they signed off.
And you also have Frank Cady.
Drucker?
Sam Drucker.
Yeah.
You can't be worth a whole lot of points. You have people on here that are almost over 100 and they're worthless. I got no points for the Queen Mother when she died. Zero.
Hold on. Yeah, Kayla?
Hey, Russ?
Yes.
Okay. Just want to let you know the little midget actor that died that was on the news.
Yeah.
The reason it was such a big deal is because he was an actor on Passions, and the day they wrote him out of the show, he died on the show. He died that evening, the day it aired.
Damn. Method actor.
Yeah, so.
Was that the only thing he was, Passions is a soap opera on, NBC?
Yeah, I think it was on Channel 5. I'm not sure what that
is. Okay. Is it the only thing he ever did?
I think he was also in another movie, but I can't remember what it was.
Oh.
What was his name?
I don't know. What's his name?
I have no idea.
We don't know. All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
Poor guy. Horrible. Nobody remembers his name.
Horrible loss for the acting world. All right, you ready to go?
Sure.
All right. 350, J.D. Ryan's on the new 105.3 FM Talk with News.
Thank you, Russ. News brought to us by Service King and by Taco Cabana. It is Wednesday, August 7th, 2002. Raul Malo, the Mavericks, singer Mavericks, is 37 today. David Duchovny turns 42. B.J. Thomas, I believe, still lives in Arlington. He's 60 today. That sang raindrops. Keep on running ahead. Spirit Airlines announced yesterday that its flights on September the 11th will be free in response to travelers' reluctance to fly on the anniversary of the terrorist attacks. American and United, the nation's two biggest carriers, have said they are cutting back their September the 11th flight schedules based on weak bookings. Number three, Delta, trimming flights for the entire work week of September 9th through the 13th. Several European airlines have also canceled flights to the United States for September the 11th. Fort Lauderdale-based Spirit has 90 flights scheduled on September the 11th. That's just a typical day for them. Customers who already paid for tickets on that day will get credit for a future flight. Travelers can take as many flights as they want on September the 11th, but tickets must be reserved by September the 8th. It's going to cost them about $500,000. Two Dallas police officers.
So you guys want to go somewhere?
September 11th?
Oh, that's during the week, isn't it?
They don't. Yeah, we have to go somewhere else because they fly mostly in Florida. Fort Lauderdale, Fort Myers, Tampa, West Palm, Orlando, Atlantic City, Oakland, California.
They fly out of here?
They do not fly out of here.
Oh, well, then that's useless.
They fly to Vegas, San Juan, Puerto Rico, Los Angeles, Denver, Detroit. They don't come in here.
All right, screw it then.
All right, two Dallas police officers suffered minor injuries overnight when their squad car crashed during a chase. The officers were in pursuit of a stolen vehicle near South Corinth Street around 12:30, and the other car slowed and hit a utility pole. Following close behind, the patrol car swerved and crashed into another utility pole. Officers were treated and released. The suspect fled. The father of a 15-month-old child was arrested over the weekend after he allegedly left the toddler alone in a van on one of the hottest days in the summer in Oklahoma City. Edward Spence was taken into custody to face child endangerment charges after the boy was found in a parking lot along Interstate 240. Police say someone passing the van heard the child crying and lifted the boy out of the vehicle. According to the witness, the baby was sweating and his skin was very red. Spence reportedly came back and told the witness he forgot the baby was still in the van.
They're only going to charge him with child endangerment?
Child endangerment. Yes, faces child endangerment charges.
Could they push that into attempted murder ever?
Well, there'd have to be an element of intent involved, and I think that might be difficult to prove.
Mm. Dan jumped somebody's ass. Was it this week or last week? Last week?
Yeah.
Dan was in Starbucks getting his...
Just coffee.
Yeah, his thing. His right. $8 cup of coffee.
Right.
Which is quite tasty, and that's the only place that Dan can get it.
Of course.
Tell your lovely story, Dan.
Well, just real quick, I got my coffee, and I turned around to put stuff in it, the sweet and low. And there's a car parked just right outside, woman coming in, engine is not running, there was one window halfway down, and the place is full. So there's not very many parking places. She would have had to walk 50 or 60 feet. This old girl sitting in the back seat, maybe 4 or 5 years old, and I was going to let it go. It made me mad, but I was just going to let it go. But then the little girl did a little wave. She was waving to me, so I waved back, and that's when I flipped out. I turned around to the woman who was coming towards me to...
Doesn't wig out because he just paid $8 for a cup of coffee.
No, little girl waves at him. He loses his mind.
Yeah. Well, she's sitting there.
Somebody runs water through little coffee beans, and then you got to pay them $8 for that. And leave them a tip.
It's $1.50.
All right.
And I'll leave a tip.
Why do you leave a tip?
I just don't want to carry the change around. I don't like carrying the change.
All right.
But it was 95 degrees outside. It was very hot. The engine was not running on the car. And... so I turned around and I said, that's a beautiful little girl you have out there in a car.
He said it loud, too.
Yeah. Did you yell at her like you yell at your daughter?
No. I just said, that's a beautiful little girl you have out in the car. Next time, why don't you let her come in the car and leave your fat ass out there in the hot sun with the engine off and the windows rolled down? And then just walked out.
Wow. You were magnificent.
Dan said everybody stared at him like he was the a-hole.
She was driving a gold Lexus, very North Dallas, the high hair and that whole thing. But she was too important to, actually park in a parking place and bring the kid in.
I'm only going to be in for a couple of minutes.
she was in there at least 5 minutes.
I've been in Starbucks before. That ain't no speedy place.
No. It was busy, but it wasn't very busy at the counter. Everybody already pretty much had their stuff and were sitting down, so she didn't have to wait long. But she still had to wait.
No, but he'll sit in a car and just... You never see anybody sitting in a car and just shut the engine off and wait.
No.
But you'll do it to your kid. And this jackass...
Oh, I forgot about the kid. But look, honey, I remember the ice cream. I carried that with me. I didn't want it to melt.
Yeah, wait a minute. The ice cream was for the kid.
Wait a minute. I'm missing something.
Extra ice cream?
No.
Oh, yeah, the kid. I think that kid got off lucky. Yeah. I think he was trying to kill him.
Well, it's just an odd location, a little just along the interstate in a parking lot. And where was the dad? That none of that's been brought out yet.
Now, had the car broken down?
No, it was in a. It didn't say that in the story.
He just got out of the car. He said he forgot about the kid.
Yep. Father left a 15-month-old child. He was arrested for allegedly leaving the toddler in the van on one of the holidays in the summer. Edward Spence is his name.
Yeah, vans are really good for not getting hot.
Oh, yeah.
Long Interstate 240. And said somebody walked by and saw the kid crying, lifted him out, called the police. He said, oops, I forgot.
I pooted.
Lovely. And no Lysol.
Man, they're good ones today. I had spicy bean burgers last night.
The black bean ones?
Yeah.
Now we can all enjoy them.
Thank you. You can, because they don't smell any different when you poot them. They don't.
It's good to know. You're eating food that smells like poots.
Yeah.
Okay. Lovely. Look at you sniffing it.
Just waiting for the bomb to drop.
You know it when it hits you, Eric.
I'm sure.
Excuse me.
Go ahead.
In non-sponsored sports, former NBA star Sylvester Williams goes on trial next week on kidnapping, rape, and other charges.
Well, of course.
A first-round draft pick of the Knicks in 1979, he faces felony charges of first-degree rape, first-degree sodomy, and first-degree kidnapping. He held a woman captive for about 24 hours, tying her up and threatening her with a knife. Prosecutors also accused Williams of having sex with a 42-year-old woman against her will.
Oh.
Yeah.
How old is he?
He is 44.
Yeah. All right.
Still 20 years different.
No, he said 40. He's how old?
44. She's 42.
2 years.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. All right, go ahead.
All right, let's see here. Probably you may have heard or may not have heard of this traveling stage performance called the Vagina Monologues.
The what?
The Vagina Monologues.
All right.
It talks about basically it's women up on stage talking about their area. Well, a British comedian, Richard Herring, has now come back. He wants to do a show called Talking C-Word, as far as a reference to the male.
Rooster.
I can't say it. Rooster. There we go.
All right.
Talking Rooster. But that's not the name of it.
Got it.
So to speak, he sent out a questionnaire to get different opinions and stories about men and their weenuses. And he found some very interesting stuff, like 35% of men claim that they have faked an orgasm with a woman. 96% of women consider the penis their friend. 17% of women have penis envy mostly because you can stand to go to the bathroom.
Yeah. They'll never know the joys of whizzing on a campfire.
No.
Without getting burnt.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
They could do it if they want to, but they just get burnt.
Oh, yeah.
That would be funny to watch.
Yeah. And 25% of women have actually laughed at the size of their man's tool.
L.A. said something was weird with my weenie, too.
She like said what? It was perfect.
She said it was unique. She said she could identify it in a crowd.
And then she said it was cute.
When she comes back, we need to get a glory hole and just stick all our cranks through
it. No, we don't.
Oh, no.
See if she can figure out which one is mine.
You know she could.
Have a lineup.
Yeah.
Why don't we get some other people besides us and you? Just you and maybe some listeners.
I just wonder what it is that's identifiable. Most of them look the same, don't they?
But look at me. I don't have any idea.
Well, when I was looking at the bus station, I mean, most of them.
I mean, there was a regular, so you could always tell when it comes to the glory hole.
Then you got ones with the triangular-shaped heads on them.
The what?
I don't know. Maybe it has an odd-shaped head on it. I don't know.
Did she say something about stripes or something? Some coloring?
Yeah, there was...
It's got no stripes.
I don't know.
Oh, God. Oh.
Many times you've shown it, we should.
Yeah, she said a stripe or a streak or something.
Fine. Here we go.
You take a look.
Hi, sweetie. Do you do that every morning, by the way?
Yeah.
Okay. I see those stripes. I got veins.
Oh, maybe that's what you meant.
What do you think about this, Dan?
I ain't looking.
Ready? Okay.
You don't even dare, do you?
It's up.
I know better.
My pants are up now. It's okay to look.
I know better.
Zip. Zip. All right. Oh, crap. There were people out in the window.
Look, it's a peep show. Get some quarters because I know the curtain's going to drop down.
Damn.
I didn't look out that way.
I think it was one of the sales guys from Wild 100. I'm going over there. There are no distinguishing marks on my crank.
That's just what she said.
What else did she say?
That was pretty much it.
Mm-hmm.
She just, if the things that she brought up yesterday were things that she wanted to get straight. It's almost like it was laying the foundation for coming down here and moving in.
Right, sure. Before you guys get married, there are certain things you need to work out.
Yeah.
You know that's where she's going with this.
Yeah, you're probably right. Why can't you just bang them?
Because they're women, you just can't. Even porn stars. This proves it. I mean, it doesn't matter if they're a librarian or a porn star. They all have the same focus.
Oh, and Jesus. Oh, good, thank God.
Well,
hold on. It's just bad things happened all at once in my head. I was thinking, all right, we get married and kids. Oh, no. Oh, good.
Yeah, you're safe.
I've been sterilized. Oh, my God. Our kid would be an absolute retard.
Some guy emailed me the other day. He goes, I guarantee you she's going to try to talk him into reversal of the vasectomy.
Uh-uh. Plus, the good thing about reversals is, according to Dr. Fetner, is once you've had the vasectomy, your body absorbs all of the sperm after ejaculation.
Right.
So after a while, your body starts fighting its own sperm and creates, I guess he said, like antibodies or something like that.
Yep, right.
So even if they reverse it, you're not as potent as you used to be.
Excellent.
Yeah. I just go to the doctor and go, okay, they undid it. Let's go. She ain't going to know.
Does she want you guys to have kids?
No, she never said anything about it. But you know, if she's a female, sooner or later she's going to want to screw up that body with kids. Jennifer Aniston and Brad Ding Dong want to have seven kids together. Seven kids. She's going to turn her breast into doilies. Ugh. Don't put that glass on that table. It's going to leave rings. Use my breast. Of all people to ruin their bodies, it's like, just don't. She's got great breasts. Flat little belly. I bet L.A. would get a big ass.
I bet she'd work out for you.
No. Why? She'd stay trim.
You think? Yeah.
She's too proud of it.
Yeah, I suppose.
Why don't you just throw that card out when she gets here? And you know I can never have kids. And just watch her reaction. See what she says. I don't care. I don't want no kids there. Or whatever.
All right.
Okay. Unlike myself, who had their checks stolen and haven't got the money back, a woman whose debit card was stolen found herself in a profit situation when she checked her bank balance.
Hold on a second. We need a break. Make this the last story.
Okay. Basically, the guy stole her credit card out of her post office box, went to the racetrack, bet on some horses, won. Instead of giving him the money, they put the money back in her account. And they got him. I like the money. It went right back into the account. She used her credit card. Did it! So he won like 10 grand and she got the cash.
Very nice.
There's news and information brought to us by Service King and by Taco Cabana. I'm J.D. Ryan on the Talk That Rocks, Texas, 101.053 FM Talk.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
All right, let's do a check on traffic.
Jonathan Dodge at the controls of the new 105.3 FM Talks, White Lightning.
Why, thank you, Russell. This report brought to you by Randall No and Taco Cabana in Dallas, southbound Loop for Walk Walker in Northwest Highway. There's a car fire on the service road, but it's causing a heavy onlooker delay. Westbound, 635 WJTI Boulevard, there's an accident blocking the two right lanes. Then at 75, the northbound, or northbound on 75, the right exit lane is blocked by another accident. Good one. Eastbound, 635 LBJ Jupiter, minor accident there. And in Fort Worth, southbound, 935, the North Freeway, Western Center Boulevard, an accident there. Why, you think belching in my ear is anything I ain't heard before? You're an amateur. This report brought to you by the Texas Lottery. You want to take a swing at huge scratch game winning? Well, here's the pitch. Shut up! I'm doing the sponsor. No talking dirty in my ear when I'm doing the sponsor. Just throw me off a bit. Where was I? Oh, yeah. You're a bastard, you know that. Want to take a swing at a huge scratch game winning ball? Here's a pitch play grand slam. The fun new game from the Texas Lottery. You can win up to $3,000. Play grand slam today. That's traffic. I'm Jonathan Dodge. And the new 105.3 FM. White for you. White day.
Thank you, Jonathan. All right, we got scattered up storms this afternoon, 72 for the overnight low, and partly sunny, 93, a little bit cooler tomorrow, 96 degrees now at the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
Even during the breaks, we're talking about L.A.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I don't get the fascination. I've dated other chicks.
They've come to know her as a person, and normally the chicks you date, you try to separate from this, and they've got to know her as a person. She's great, had a great personality.
She's beautiful.
In a way that's, he's ever had a point. It's hard for a chick that's a secretary at State Farm, let's say, to listen to this show and go, yeah, that's my boyfriend. Yeah, there's other girls up there. Yeah, and they're showing their breasts, and he's rubbing all over them and doing breast exams. And yeah, he's got a porn star up there now, and he's shoving a little vibrating toy up in her, but I love him. L.A. is one of the few people that would go, yeah, he's awake there.
Right.
It's a go-go race out.
That's my little butt nut ramming that thing in my that chick day.
She would let it roll off her because of what she does.
She gets it.
It's almost impossible for a chick with a normal job to get it.
Right.
I think that's part of your attraction to her.
No, it's not.
No, I really do. The fact.
Okay.
Well, seriously, the fact that both of you are in professions that are entertainment oriented.
I don't run around showing my portal.
No,
you do occasionally.
Yeah, actually, you do.
You have done that.
You pulled out your crank about 10 minutes ago, as I recall.
Nobody saw it but me.
Well, it's because we all turned around.
I knew you would.
You had two girls in here one time, both looking directly at it, close range, and their pictures.
Let us not recount the litany of misadventures.
Wait a minute. What chicks were looking at it?
There was the point. I can't remember the porn star's name, but then the chick from the studio audience came in, and they both...
Oh, Terry Weigel.
There we go.
Oh, well, that wasn't... She was...
So a normal girl would be able to listen to...
Wait a minute. Hold on. Wait a second. First of all... Okay, wait.
First of all, I'm reliving the moment.
Yeah.
Wait. Nobody say nothing for a minute. I'm getting dizzy. All right. Yeah, Terry Weigel was in the studio. We were doing the shower thing together.
Correct.
All right. And I kept telling the chick taking the pictures, don't take any shots of my crank because I don't want anybody seeing it.
Right.
All right.
Now let's assume for a minute you have a normal.
So Terry Weigel and that chick being in the studio had nothing to do with it. That was just an excuse for me to get naked with another porn star. I didn't know Terry Weigel was going to do what she did when she got down on her knees.
But you were,
and I didn't know the listener chick was going to come over and have some too.
Doesn't matter. You were naked, standing next to a porn star, dripping wet in a shower. The average chick.
Oh, I got to grab myself.
My nipples. The average person isn't going to have a hard time listening to that sitting in her office at IBM and going, I can deal with this. I can deal with it. Now, what are they doing? Oh, I can deal with that. It's tough.
I agree.
But she said if she stopped porn, I'd have to stop that.
She was making a point. I mean, yeah.
Well, I'm not going to date her if she's still doing porn. The relationship's not going to go anyplace if she keeps doing porn.
She said she'd quit in about a year.
Yeah.
When she had her own business.
Once she gets enough money to support herself so that you don't even have to support her. Look, I'll draw up a premarital agreement for you if that's your concern.
I'm not going to get married.
They could just live together.
I'm not going to live with her. Why? What is it with chicks? You just can't. I would let her come down, Sarah, as much as she wanted, as long as she didn't try and get attached. Why is it? She always reads something into screwing her.
Because she's human.
And she's a woman. They can't separate it. You've said it yourself.
She can. She's a porn star. She has sex with guys all the time.
But that's business.
She doesn't love them.
She compartmentalizes.
Well, why can't she do that with me?
Because you're someone that she's romantically involved with.
Thank you, Everett.
How can you not see this?
I understand that she's romantically involved. I just, why is it we just can't hang?
Because she's fallen for you.
Okay.
You've done the same thing. You've had sex with women that you didn't care about.
Right.
You've also had sex with women you did care about.
Uh-huh.
She's doing the same thing. She's having sex with people she doesn't care about and having sex with a man that she does care about. And you can separate it. It is different. She's more of a guy in that way. She can separate it.
Whatever. All right, who's talking in the hall?
People about to die.
Who was it? Were they in Bob's office?
Yeah.
Who was it?
Midday
Jake. Oh. Bob knows better than that.
I know.
What is it, David?
Yeah, what's been going on with Billy Lee Davis? Haven't heard you talk about him in a while.
I don't know. Anybody know?
You're supposed to know.
I just tried to get his record played. I haven't heard anything. I don't know. As far as I know, I don't even think we still have a CD in here.
Well, weren't you, like, promoting him?
I was. It didn't take off. How long does it take to turn a song into a hit? 10 days?
Quite a while.
Quite a while. And you have to have radio stations willing to play it, which you didn't have in this market. Other stations did. Abilene and a few other.
Yeah. That's all I know was Abilene. I don't know. I guess we can find out. Oh, he's got an appearance. I think at Hastings Records in McKinney on Saturday, I think.
Mm-hmm.
What are you writing down, Dan? Is that his phone number?
Yeah, I've got his number if you want to call him.
I don't even have a CD in here anymore.
I've got a copy.
Where is it?
Better Sounds website, the appearance.
Yeah, it probably is.
Call that number if you just want to call him. And here's the CD.
Oh. Oh, I dialed 214. Which one?
The first one. There's two numbers on there.
That's okay. Two. I guess I should have said all that on the air. Should I?
Maybe not.
I will.
I didn't say the last 4 digits.
ASI, may I help you?
Is Billy in?
This is Billy.
Hi, Billy. It's Russ Martin. Can I talk to you on the air?
Yes, you can.
Good. What's up with your CD?
Oh, not much. Right now, it's just been very exciting. So far, we've gotten a lot of different things that we're going to go do as far as appearances are concerned.
And now you got the thing Saturday, right?
There's a thing Saturday at the Hastings in McKinney from 12 to 2.
What are you going to do there?
I'm going to play there, and they're also going to sell a bunch of CDs. I'm going to do some CD signings and all.
Okay.
And then coming up on the 16th, I'm going to be on the Texas Music Hall of Fame picking party in Carthage, Texas.
And you didn't call me? What is that?
That's actually where they...
All right, what happened?
You turned him off.
I did not. Oh, did I?
Yeah.
No, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
All right.
Start over.
Yeah.
Well, coming up the 16th, I'm going to be at the Texas Country Music Hall of Fame picking party in Carthage, Texas.
Oh, that's right. That's why I accidentally turned you off. I was shocked.
Oh.
All right. Now, what is that?
That's where they induct new inductees into the Texas Country Music Hall of Fame. And we're going to do a picking party on the Friday night. And then on Saturday night, they're having a big concert with Tanya Tucker and Gene Watson.
Damn. Tanya Tucker was somebody who used to be hot in the 80s, too.
Yeah, that's right.
She's not hot now. You're hotter than she is.
Well, thanks.
Yeah.
Then on the 15th of November, I've got a private party I'm doing. And then on the 29th is the Wolf Fireworks to Music.
That's in November?
November, correct. The 29th, I'll be playing for the Wolf Fireworks to Music.
And they won't play your record on the air?
No, they will not. Well, so far as I know, I haven't heard it yet.
What about that dump in Plano?
195.
The range. Why?
Yeah, the range. KHYI.
Correct. I haven't heard anything from them either, so I don't know.
And that's the one we got the ugly email from?
Yes.
Yeah, I think so.
Some jackass named Bruce or Josh or something like that. Who was it, Dan?
I think it was Josh.
Yeah.
Joshua.
Well, you got to keep in mind, too, that that station plays mostly Americana music.
It's a dump. They should play anything, and they should have welcomed all the attention that they got. They don't even show up in the Arbitron ratings.
Well, they play mostly Americana music, and what I've done
I don't even know what that means.
Country and Western. So it's a little bit more folk-oriented.
Older bass than this?
She wrote call.
That's pretty old. Yeah. That's Merle Haggard old. My farts stink today.
Great.
So this isn't old enough sounding for them?
Well, I'm not sure. It's either that they didn't like the music or possibly the attention.
That's
because
wrong.
They had just gotten the disc prior to all of this. So, there's not much I can do about that. But I still listen to them and I still appreciate what they do over there.
They're idiots.
Another bit of exciting news is I got featured on Coast to Coast Country Magazine, which has 55,000 member readership, and I've got a full page ad there as well as an article, and they put me on the cover.
Where is that magazine published?
That magazine is published here in Dallas.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
So you're on the cover?
I'm on the cover, right.
Has that already come out?
It's come out already, but it's only to subscribers. You can get it at any local Opry, though. Like the Grapevine Opry or any Opry like that.
Did you get more than one copy?
I didn't. She only mailed me one, but I will get more.
Yeah, I'd like to have a copy.
I can get you a copy.
Autograph, please.
I will do that.
Hold on a second. My favorite part's coming up. Didn't the song start out as a joke? Isn't that what I heard you say?
Well, it wasn't a joke. It was because everyone said I don't write anything up-tempo, upbeat. So I went ahead and wrote a song that was up-tempo and upbeat.
She wrote call me.
Song you wrote for the album?
No, actually, that one I wrote a long time ago.
Oh. And you're gonna play our White Trash Party?
Yes.
Good.
She wrote call me.
That is if ever she'll be able to back me up.
That wasn't me.
Yeah, I know it. Can you do backup on this, Everett?
Sure.
Can you do it in the style that he's... Yeah.
Yeah, we work something out.
All right.
That'd be great. I think. Thanks a lot.
That'd be a lot of fun.
Can you play steel guitar?
I've yet to try.
But I'm sure you could.
Yeah,
you play keyboards, right?
Yeah.
Electric and acoustic?
Yes.
Guitar. What else do you play?
Violin and flute.
Do you really?
Yeah.
You savant. All right, hold on a second. All right, so we're all caught up now on the Billy Lee Davis stuff.
Correct. The only other thing that was interesting that has occurred is that I'm being featured also in the Adult News magazine, which...
Is that the one with boobs and cranks in it?
Well, I didn't know exactly what that was, but
yeah.
They said they wanted to feature me in it, and I said okay, and then I went...
Is this like a pictorial?
Well, they'll just feature the album and talk about it. They did.
Oh, you should do some nude shots.
No.
Cowboy hat over your crank or hanging off of it.
Yeah. I don't think I could do that. But they featured Dolly Parton last week, so they're going to feature me this week. So that's kind of interesting.
Yeah. congratulations.
Hey, any publicity is good publicity, right?
No.
Uh-oh.
All right. All this stuff on your website, BillyLeeDavis.com?
All of it is getting put on as quick as we can. There's always a day lag to get stuff put on, but, yeah, as quick as we can.
Okay. All right.
Well, thank you very much.
Thanks for the update.
Thanks for all the help.
You're welcome.
See.
It's very popular, Billy Lee Davis.
There's a couple other good cuts on there. It is. It's, he's got a lot of slow songs in there, country ballads and waltzes. But
what other good cuts?
Cut 7 is a pretty good drinking song.
Hold on.
Look at Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Been listening. Well, I went ahead and listened to the whole thing. I like this.
Yeah.
It don't,
old
country this don't make my butt cramp up as bad as the other ones.
The dog that bit me.
This one's starting to make me gurgle.
This one's, that song's just like the ones we used to listen to on Channel 11.
Yeah, he's, Dan's right. This is crap my parents used to, sorry, Billy. This is a crap my parents used to listen to when I was a kid. K-Box.
Yep. It's exactly like it. It just kind of, even though it's a new song, it kind of brings back old memories.
That's a life beating song.
So give me some of that hair.
What else are you enjoying on this album, Dan?
Track number 5, it's kind of fun. About coming home and his wife moved out and kids are gone, so he's drinking a bottle of 90 proof and playing his guitar because he loves it more than he loved her.
And whizzing flames. oh, Billy.
I got home tonight around 2.
Oh, no. What else, Dan?
Those are the songs I like.
None of them kick me like the first one.
No, that first one, he should do more up-tempo.
I just now noticed something. He can't sing.
That's why he needs to stay away from the ballads and the waltzes.
Damn. It didn't hit me until just now.
He's not listening.
Listen.
I know.
Hey, he's a little stiff on the ballads. He needs to loosen up a little bit. And
Billy can't sing.
I can't.
Like a kid's book.
I got home tonight around 2. With no sign of the kids for you.
Now, bless his heart.
Yeah.
I was overcome with.
That's a bad note. Bad too. Yeah. Billy, don't do these anymore. Don't do that no more. Stick with what made you big.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Stick with the hitmaker song.
She wrote call on me.
See, Dan's right. Up tune.
Yeah, there we go.
No more ballads, Billy. Sorry.
But you can't sing.
Alright, we'll be back.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
You don't know it's mine.
I saw you going in. And then you came out a moment later. I'm coming around the hall. I had to go too, so I went in, and it's clogged. It's nasty. At least tell maintenance so they can have somebody go in there with a coat hanger and break it up and get it down the toilet.
I kicked at it.
You didn't kick in.
No.
You just kicked at the sides.
I slapped on it. I can't help it that it won't flush. Rotten plumbing in this building. This building's 45 years old.
That's a big dookie.
Told you I had to go. Did you see the tire threads in it?
Did it scratch coming out?
Yeah, it did.
It's all those nuts you've been eating.
I suppose. Thank God for those handicap rails in there.
You hover?
No. had to grab a hold of it with both hands and just hang on. You never do that?
Grab on the rails and hold on?
Yeah, just go.
No, I can't say I've had one that could do that to me.
Yeah.
You can't bear down properly if you don't grab the rails.
Yeah. I swear to God, I was like 30 before I knew what those rails were for.
I have to have some installed at my house.
I just thought they were people that, you know, had not enough fiber in their diet.
No, for handicapped people.
I didn't know that. Because that's what I always used them for.
I use them to, as Dan said, hover over public toilets.
Yeah.
I just put toilet paper on the seat.
Well, this place is much better. They've got the little paper
ring. This place is a dump.
Well, but they've at least got the little paper ring thingies. Now, if everybody did what you did, it'd be nasty. Just, it'd be horrible.
I can't help it that it's clogged up.
It was poking up out of the water.
Yeah, it was. Mm. I left a little Loch Ness. It hurt, too.
Lovely.
That was one of the ones that you go, all right, this is the one. This is the one that's not coming out.
This is my Elvis Dookie. Yeah.
They're going to find me laying down sideways with 20 pounds of white fecal matter in my bowels.
And the first thing they say when they walk in, get that one.
Yeah.
Poking up by the water.
That one's still trying to get out.
There's something very gratifying about having one that actually kind of makes it above the surface.
Quit it!
Well, they're so rare.
Little mountain.
It's like you're making sandcastles. I thought this was going to be another one that I was going to have to push back in.
You can't push them back in.
Yes, you can.
They've got to come out eventually.
Push it back in and then mash around inside.
Oh.
Kind of break it up.
Oh.
Yeah, you can hear your colon lurch sometimes when you do that.
Never
are you talking about like a loose transmission?
Something like that. It's sort of gargles.
Like a loose U joint.
It's trying to shift into out mode. You
know? What is it, Phil?
Hey. We'll stop talking about Mr. Hankey for a while. Let me ask you a serious question.
Mm.
I've been listening to your show for a long time. You know, you've had a lot of, let's say, young ladies on your show.
Mm-hmm.
And I missed it, or I started listening after, or whatever. But how did you start up with L.A. Le Mans?
And we come across her. Was she?
Yeah.
She was in town doing a feature.
Yeah, I never.
And they brought her into the studio to, I think we were going to paint her.
But she was in town
for Pandora's Box. You and I went down there that night to see her.
No, that was Danny Sexton.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That was a different one that I banged.
Oh, sorry.
L.A. was in town. I don't know. She was going to be appearing at one of the topless bars, and they called us, and they said, hey, you want this new porn star, da-da-da.
Yeah,
and
then, she was brand new.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
And then she comes in and wants to do all the stuff in the studio and then invited me out to the club. I think she was even sick the first time she came in because she danced at the club, and then we sat in the back and we talked for a while. And she starts telling me about all about her life.
Hmm. Well, the thing I'm really curious about, too, is now, is she just like your main squeeze, like when you're on the radio, or is it in real life, too? Like when you go home, is she what you go home to sometimes?
No, she doesn't live in town. She lives in Boston.
Well, I knew that, but I mean,
or yeah. Something.
But when she's in town.
I don't talk to her that much off the air. I was supposed to call her last night, and I forgot.
Uh-oh.
I reminded you.
What?
I reminded you.
I forgot her number. I don't know it. It's a long distance. I don't call it that often.
You could have just called me back or emailed me back and asked me what the number is.
Hmm.
Mm. I've always got it.
Okay. Anyway, does that answer your question?
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Yeah.
In fact, she did the best T-shirt we ever had that went on Hootie Hoot.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
That one came out perfect. Her breasts were so round and firm.
I think we got $500-$600 for that shirt.
You painted her, you put the shirt on her, and when it peeled off, it just came off perfect.
Mm. Then I used the rascally rabbit on her.
Mm.
Yes.
That was the first time I met her.
Yes. People still call in wanting her to just say rascally rabbit.
Mm. I think Norm at Condoms to Go sold out of those that day.
Before the show was over.
Yeah.
Yeah, because she couldn't stop talking about it.
Yeah, when it's porn star good, you know it's good.
Yeah.
Porn star seal of approval.
Mm. What were we talking about for that guy called?
Dookies.
Oh, yeah.
Dookies, yeah.
Somebody should really go in there and do something about that.
Well, we have a maintenance guy here. You can, you're fully capable of telling him to go in there and break it up.
Who's got a cell?
I don't want him to think it's mine.
Who's got a cell phone? Is it James that's got to do it?
Yeah.
Give him the cell phone. I want to hear him on the phone as he goes down there and takes a look at it.
He was out in the hall a minute ago.
Yeah.
In fact, you walked right past him. You could have mentioned it to him when you were walking by.
I don't want to. It's not my fault it wouldn't flush. I tried to flush. It's not like I just left it.
Well, you should have held it until you got home then.
I wasn't going to hold it. Did you see it?
Oh, you did it?
You dookie smiled at me.
Little wink.
All right, Patty.
Sometimes if they're really...
Everett.
Oh.
By the way, you use too much toilet paper.
I had to wipe.
Yeah, but you use half a roll.
I like to be clean.
You can be clean without using the entire roll.
You got to. What I do is I don't push that hard, and I use a lot of paper, as opposed to pushing really hard.
Right,
and only using a few sheets.
But to conserve paper.
I don't give a rat's ass about paper. Look how cheap that stuff is.
I know,
anyway.
But then
I won't even steal it.
Well, that adds to the unflushability of the toilet.
Yeah, we have really bad plumbing here.
You're using twice as much paper as you need to, and it adds to the pile.
Sorry.
At least start flushing halfway through.
Okay. Yeah, I have to do that at home.
Next time you have a good one, go upstairs to the sales department. A, their bathroom's cleaner.
Oh, is it really?
So one holder, it's got a lock. Yeah. Plus, you could leave it up there.
Yeah, I never, ever like using public toilets, even in this building that we work, just because I've always got this fear somebody's going to kick the door open and kick my ass while I'm sitting on the pot.
You can't do anything about it. Your pants are down.
Yeah.
You're vulnerable.
How primal of you.
What?
I mean, really, well, that's how animals are. That's why we've had this conversation before, but I've maintained all along that animals look embarrassed when they're taking a squat. And that's why, because they're vulnerable. They're vulnerable to attack. Don't look
but
at me.
But they're still in a position where they can run.
Yeah, but they're going to be stringing stuff out behind them.
I don't think they care.
They do.
It's not like they got to run off and their pants are still down between their four legs.
They get embarrassed.
They don't get embarrassed.
You've never taken your dog for a walk and seen Abby get embarrassed when she squats?
She doesn't get embarrassed.
She does. I've seen her. She looks around those little eyes, look up at you. Please don't gaze at me.
Don't laugh.
What?
Can't find him.
Well, at least get on the cell phone. He just held his arms up in the air like I got all day to wait on him. You should go take a look at it, Everett.
Is it really good?
Yeah, they're good. You got a cell phone?
Not with me. No. Yeah. Is it a Sidewinder?
It's all of them.
Really?
Yeah, it's a potpourri.
It's just a bowl filler.
Yeah.
How much you clear the water by?
About that much.
Wow.
Damn. Yeah.
That's impressive.
It is.
Dan's right. You should flush in shifts.
That's a turret sticking out of there.
All right, you ready for news?
Yeah.
All right. Give any time to figure out what the hell he's doing. All right, 4:51, J.D. Ryan's on the new 105.3 FM Talk with News.
Here's some more audio, by the way. This is brought to us by Mitsubishi and by Dell Computers. An FBI informant wearing a wire to secretly record a conversation with a tax assessor ended up making what is believed to be the only known uninterrupted audio recording of the September 11th attacks on the World Trade Center. This will be cut number one. Steve McArdle is a tax consultant. He was at the Marriott World Trade Center Hotel to meet with the assessor as part of a probe. The conversation was being taped by two FBI agents just a few blocks away from the Twin Tower. Hold on, Z.
Do what?
He leaves at 4.
What does he leave at 4 for? Oh. Give a... are you on one of the phones?
Yeah.
Hold on a second. Is that you?
No.
No. What about that one?
Yeah. Hey, Dan.
That ain't gonna quit it. Is that you?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Give Everett the phone. Go take a look.
Okay.
Don't take your Dr. Pepper. Let's go. He takes it anyway.
Thirsty.
You won't be after you see it.
Go ahead.
Okay. Which one is it in?
There are only two toilets.
Well, I don't want to be surprised. I want to know ahead of time.
Nah, it'll be all right.
Okay. Oh, dear God, I smell it already. Oh, no. It looks like you flushed a pony.
Touch it, Everett.
A Shetland.
Touch it.
No. No, it's horrific.
Try flushing it right now. See what happens.
Oh, God.
It overflows.
I got to go back in there. I'm not kidding. You can smell it coming down the hall before you even open the door.
Try to flush it.
All right. God. Make me grip my teeth. Oh, Jesus. This is horrible. Here it goes. Oh. Oh.
Did it go?
I don't know.
Well, look.
I'm afraid. Yeah, it's gone.
All right, congratulations.
Wow.
All right, thanks.
Yeah, sure.
Sometimes if you let them sit for a while, they'll start breaking up on their own.
Yeah. Good. All right, I'm sorry. What was your story? All right.
Let's start again. FBI informant wearing a wire to secretly record a conversation with a city tax assessor ended up making what is believed to be the only known uninterrupted audio recording of the September 11th attack on the World Trade Center. Stephen McCardle, who's a tax consultant, was at the Marriott World Trade Center Hotel to meet with the assessor as part of a probe. And the conversation was being taped by two FBI agents just a couple of blocks away from the Twin Towers. On the tape, which we have here, the conversation about bribery turns into a record of chaos, starting with a muffled boom of the first hijacked plane hitting the North Tower. And this goes on for like a minute.
That was an explosion.
The minute you hear a roar, they say that's the jet fuel going down the center of the building.
Where were they in the building?
They were somewhere in the middle floors.
They were in the Garden Cafe.
And that's where in the building?
Down, what do they call those? Mezzanine?
Like on the second or third floor?
It's like the third floor, second or third floor.
They heard it all the way down there?
Yeah, they heard the boom, and then the fuel just came pouring down the center of the building. Part of the building is open down through the center.
Oh.
And in a moment here, just about 45 seconds in, there's an edit you don't hear, but it's audio of the second plane hitting. But there's no, I just cut out the ABC reporter. Although I got this from ABC News.
Obviously. Listen to that.
Can you imagine being the FBI guy sitting a few blocks away in a van going, what in the hell? Not being able to do anything about it. Anyway, all those people got out safely.
I don't think I would have believed it.
Mm-mm.
Even sitting there watching it happen.
No.
Damn, that's freaky. Mm-hmm. Was that all the audio?
Yeah. Well, we have some other audio, but it's more than
that. Well, I mean, of that.
Of that. That's all there is.
Okay.
Okay, the West Nile virus death toll is rising in Louisiana as the virus spreads across the U.S.
I think I got to go again.
Oh, no, you don't.
Yeah, I think I do.
No, I think you're done. I think
that's
it.
Why didn't you get it all the first time?
I don't know. My Easy Bake's still going.
And what was all that stuff hanging on the side?
Shush! Got up too soon.
West Nile virus is now in Illinois for the first time and festering in several other states. A 76-year-old New Orleans
area. Did he say infestering?
Festering in several other states.
Oh.
And festering in several other states. 76-year-old New Orleans area woman was the fifth Louisiana resident to die from the virus. After hundreds of birds and mosquitoes across Illinois were found to have the disease this summer, they're still trying to spray for it and looking for it in Texas.
One of those news services that sends me stuff all the time.
Yeah.
Sent me one that warning that the West Nile virus is the Winston Mitty's analysis and commentary. It's a guy we had on long ago has continued to email me.
Mm-hmm.
And he says the West Nile virus is an epidemic that has been mounted by Saddam Hussein and sent over here as a weapon of war.
Yeah.
To try to weaken us.
Yeah, that's a good one. A virus that only affects 1% of the people that get it.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yes.
Bob McNeil thinks he's got it.
Why?
He's running around in the hall.
My eyes are sore. I got a headache. I haven't been able to shake this for a few days. Look at the West Nile. Well, it does exhibit flu-like symptoms. But
that's exactly. He goes, I don't know what it is, and I can't shake it.
Could just be a summer cold.
I like to think it's the West Nile.
The chances of a human getting it are 1 in 40,000. Texas only has 10 known cases.
All right.
Map reading is probably the main source of conflict between couples while driving, but the assertion that women are incapable of reading a map correctly has, unfortunately, to the female sex, now been backed up by several studies on their abilities. Men have used this convenient theory of the female lack of judgment to criticize anything from a woman's ability to reverse into a parking space to berating her when she fails to differentiate north from south while reading a map. But now it seems like it is true. Men find that the instructions on a map, they find it easier to follow. Women do far much better with the verbal set of instructions. It's according to a big survey they put out with landmarks. Women do better with landmarks.
How hard is it to follow a map? The top part of it's north.
Yes. Well, chicks have a hard time with north, south, east, and west.
It's the same on every map. It's not like it changes from gas station to gas station. There's the map. That's north. That's south. That's east, and that's west.
They don't do well with that.
If you turn it this way, now that's north.
But you've got to apply it to the real world. I think that's where they have.
Yeah,
to
they'd go. Rather.
Well, he said they can't read a map.
They don't do as well reading maps. They do better going. You get down to Target. You turn right. You go down about a half a mile, and turn left there at the 7-Eleven.
That's where I get lost. I like to have it on paper. I like to have a map. I like to see what things are around me. I like to know when I've gone too far. Read a map. Go ahead.
Okay. Barry Bonds, 599th homer, wasn't even the most exciting part of the wild victory for San Francisco Giants. Bond moved into the doorstep of the elusive 600 homer club with a early three-run shot, and the Giants scored three runs in the eighth inning to beat Chicago 11-10 last night.
Is that a big deal?
That's a big
deal. Huge.
600 is going to be huge.
I think Hank Aaron, Babe Ruth, and maybe Ted Williams are the only three major league players in history to have ever reached that mark.
Then I will say, wow.
Okay. Very nice. Be duly impressed. Also be impressed about this. The premiere of the Anna Nicole Show on Sunday produced huge ratings for E! Show earned a 4.1 Nielsen rating, which makes it the highest rated reality series premiere on cable ever.
That's Can you believe that they get excited over a 4.1 rating?
Yeah. Well, it's cable. You don't have that much density.
When JD and I, when we were doing the TV show that was on Fox and then over in Paramount.
Right.
We have like a, not every week, but 7, 8. Oh,
yeah.
Rating?
Yeah. A 4 was considered very average.
Really?
Yeah.
We had a 10 once.
Did we have a 10?
Yeah, because we had a big party and we broke a 10.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. To put that in perspective, the Osbournes only debuted with a 2.8 rating that past spring. And John Madden's debut on Monday Night Football this week drew an 8.6 rating. That's better than the Dennis Miller debut, which scored an 8 a couple years ago. Year ago, whatever. Total Guitar Magazine conducted a poll to determine the 100 greatest guitarists in the world, and you'll never guess who won. You want to take a guess? Everett, you should be in on this. Who's on the? I got the top 20 if you want to go through them.
Eddie Van Halen's always a good guess.
See where Eddie is. He's number 7. You're correct.
Angus Young?
Number 20 out of 20.
Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Number 19. Very good.
Steve Vai.
Steve Vai. Very good. Number 10.
Who's the Satch man? Joe
Satriani?
Yeah.
Yep, he's number 6.
What about Yngwie Malmsteen?
No.
He's not even on the list?
No, no.
Well, not the top. What do you got, the 20?
I don't know, the top 20.
Was that
the top one?
Motorhead? What was he in?
No, he had his own solo group. He won a Grammy first year he cut an album.
Was he in something else besides being on his own?
He was in a couple of minor bands. Alcatraz and a band called Steeler. Nothing you've ever heard of.
Oh. Let's see. Eric Clapton?
Clapton's number 3. Very good.
Jimi Hendrix.
Jimi Hendrix.
Do they have to be alive?
I think that's why I'm on here. Hang on. Oh, yeah, Jimi Hendrix. You ready? Number 1. You got it.
For what? Because he played a left-handed guitar, and he died in his own yak.
I never thought it was...
He was pretty good.
Yeah, I can see that.
And you put Angus Young at 20th?
Number 20.
Yeah.
Well, he didn't put him at 20th. The list did, but...
Well, Everett doesn't seem to disagree with that.
No, I don't disagree with that at all.
Really?
No. No, I think Angus Young is a great guitar player, and AC/DC is arguably the best rock band ever, just in terms of their music, but in terms of just being a great guitar player, I'd put Jimi Hendrix ahead of Angus Young.
Does that include on stage or just the sound?
The sound.
Okay. Because even JD's not a big AC/DC fan, and we went last year or year before when they were here.
Amazing.
And just to watch Angus, because he's got to be in his 40s now, well into his 40s. Played his ass off.
Fantastic show.
Oh, yeah, he's great. I'm not taking anything away from him. And I mean, the fact that he's alive and Hendrix is dead.
And where was Eddie Van Halen?
Eddie Van Halen was number 7.
Ted Nugent on the list at all?
Nope. Didn't make top 20 anyway. This is top. There's a top 100 list you can only get in the magazine called Total Guitar. Brian May of Queen, number 5. Slash, number 4. Eric Clapton, number 3. Jimmy Page, number 2. Jimi Hendrix, number 1.
Who was between 10 and 20?
Angus Young, number 20, Stevie Ray Vaughan, Jeff Beck, Gary Moore.
Who's Gary Moore?
Gary Moore, played with, I'm blanking on who he played with.
Right.
Thin Lizzy, maybe.
Zach Wilde at 16, Mark
Ozzy.
Koffler, Dire Straits.
Yeah,
Knopfler.
Knopfler, thank you. Kurt Cobain, Tom Morello.
Kurt Cobain?
Kurt Cobain, number 14.
Please.
Alright.
Tom Morello, James.
That?
He's Rage Against the Machine.
Okay.
James Hetfield from Metallica. Carlos Santana is number 11. And Steve Vai?
Vai
is number 10.
Huh. I like Gary Hoey, too.
Yeah,
I don't guess he's big enough.
Probably not.
Or as well known.
Yeah.
He might have made the top 100. How many could there be, really?
There are a lot of good guitar players out there.
I'd have stuck Eddie Van Halen up higher.
Yeah. I'd go with you on that.
Who's number 2?
Number 2 is Jimmy Page.
I'd definitely put him ahead of Slash from Guns N' Roses.
He's number 4.
I think I would have put him ahead of Led Zeppelin, too.
I don't know. Have you ever seen The Song Remains the Same?
The movie?
No. Yeah. Jimmy Page is pretty amazing.
Yeah. And finally. Hold on a second. What is it, Patrick?
Yeah, I wanted to ask where you think Nugent would be on that list.
I'd have put him in the top 20.
I saw him on Sunday, and he was incredible, absolutely incredible.
Oh, that's right. He was at the Bronco Bowl, wasn't he?
Yeah.
It was a great show.
Did you go, Dan?
Yeah.
I did, too.
I thought you guys were supposed to go to the movie shoot.
I spaced the movie.
Thanks, Patrick.
No, I talked to Alan on...
Ali. I don't care what he changed his name to.
he likes using Alan. So
it doesn't it doesn't anglicize
it
at all.
Well, he doesn't spell it like Alan, either. It's Ali with an N.
Well, makes me sound like I'm more from here. Your last name is Bijan. It doesn't help.
No, I told him I wasn't going
to. So all you guys stiffed him?
I spaced it.
I hurt my back.
You did not.
I might have.
Eddie, did you go?
No, actually my computer crashed and I had Matt come over and we worked on that all day.
Okay. Why didn't you guys just tell him, no, I'm not coming, when he asked?
I had planned on going, but... The shoot was, he moved it to the evening.
That's when he said it was, when he talked to us, on the air.
I had thought he had said that it was in the morning, because it started.
No, it was going to end in the morning.
Oh, at 5 in the morning. Yeah. So when he told me that, that's when I said, I can't come to that. I'm going to the concert. So
I knew everybody would stiff him. That's why I said no up front, because I knew nobody else was going to go.
He kept telling me over and over, I really wanted Russ in the movie.
I'm not going to ride no donkey for him.
Oh, there was somebody else. No, the little kid was going to ride the donkey, and they're going to have an old man leading the donkey. You were going to be the man running through the through desert, and you stop and talk to the old man and then run.
No, no,
run away.
Pass. He wanted this in the movie. Should have said something long before he got to the end of it.
Yeah.
A reshoot, actually. Wasn't even the end. It was a reshoot of something they had to redo.
Oh.
So they really had finished the movie. This is something that screwed up, whatever.
Oh, well.
Finally, a performing bear entertaining prison old folks in a German retirement home accidentally sat on a 90-year-old woman and killed her. Nora. Nora, the 485-pound brown bear, was being led into a hall, and she stumbled over the woman's wheelchair, lost her footing, and fell on the woman. Later died of her injuries. The bear was only supposed to sit on a bench and eat fruit while the handler talked about the history of bears. It declined to give his full name because they're up on charges of possible manslaughter. Squashing me, Mom, with a bear.
So, there's a bear.
Yeah.
Oh, man, there's a Happy the Clown or something. A bear went into an old folks' home and killed
her. Home. Just
a dancing bear dancing, killed an old lady.
Sat, tripped on the wheelchair. Landed on her. And, you know, funny. The lady died. What's up? Quit it.
I got a beard.
Oh, sad. Nora the bear.
Are there any pictures?
Not in this story.
God, why can't I get a case like that?
Performing bear. I'm glad we... You like it when old people die. That's
well... It's got nothing to do with old people dying.
It's
yeah, it's the fact that it's like Happy the Clown.
Yeah.
That old guy really lived in Balt Springs.
Mm-hmm.
That was his name, Happy the Clown. And he died when his trailer went up in flames. Him and his dog, named Dog, expired in the flames.
So, she's dead. There's news and information.
There's got to be a 911 call here someplace.
Brought to us by Mitsubishi and by Dell Computers. I'm J.D. Ryan on the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up. Call Russ now at 214-787-1053.
All right, 520 check on traffic. Jonathan Dodge at the controls of the new 105.3 FM Talks. Wyatt Lightner.
Why, thank you, Russell. This report brought to you by the Department of Public Safety at Taco Cabana in Dallas, northbound I-35, Simmons and Crosby. There's a serious accident. It's got all lanes blocked northbound, causing very heavy delays southbound. Onlooker delays. Also in Dallas, northbound I-35, Simmons at Reunion Boulevard. There's an accident blocking the right lane that's causing slowdown on the I-30 in Mesquite, northbound 635 LBJ at Town Center Boulevard. There's a disabled tractor trailer. It's off to the shoulder now, but the delay still remains. On 75 Central northbound, under the Coit flyover, there's a stalled vehicle blocking the left center lane. And westbound 635 LBJ at Chelsea got an accident there. And out, on Woody Road at US 175, there's a skating rink on fire. That's causing onlooker delays on the eastbound 175, causing delays back to Beltline. This report brought to you by the Texas Lottery. Step up to the plate, Texas. It's time to play Grand Slam, the exciting new scratch game from the Texas Lottery. That's a home run for fun. You can win up to $3,000. Play Grand Slam today. That's traffic. I'm Jonathan Dodge in the new 105.3 FM. Fight.
All right, Jonathan, we have some storms developing to our east, and normally that wouldn't be a problem, except they're coming to the west. Normally they go the other way between Greenville and the Rockwall line of storms. So more behind that, probably the next 45 minutes to an hour, the Dallas area should be seeing some showers. And like I said, some more popping up to the east coming this way. It should be 93 for the high tomorrow. We have 96 degrees and partly cloudy skies currently at the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
What's the name of this thing? Adult News and Entertainment. I don't know how you describe this magazine. Screw magazine.
It's basically of all the strip clubs and adult activities in the Dallas area.
Leading source for adult entertainment.
There we go.
And, what is it? 2 pages in. Look at the cans.
Russ.
Mm-hmm.
Article.
Mm-hmm.
It's
on the second page. All right. Weekly music review. Billy Lee Davis needs airplay. You heard rising music star Billy Lee Davis' CD, Summertime in Texas, debuted on the Russ Martin Show, KYNG 105.3 FM. Or at least the first few lines of track one, Call Me. Now Russ Martin is hell-bent on getting this musician some much-needed airtime to launch a successful career. After listening to the first track on the Russ Martin Show, we ventured to Mr. Davis's website, BillyLeeDavis.com. Blah, blah, blah. He sounds like the next George Jones. That's what they say.
Okay.
And that tells you how to order Summertime in Texas off of Billy's site. I guess they did an interview because they've got quotes from him. Of course, they could have pulled that off his website. And then at the bottom of the article, they've got how to make Billy a big star. It's all the information that I've got on terrydorsey.com.
Mm-hmm. They have listed.
Yeah, they printed all this here. Nice article. It's kind of weird. It's a music review of a country song. In a porn mag that was played on a talk station.
Yeah. Yeah, kind of odd.
I didn't even have his picture. Cover of the CD.
I already knew.
Nice article. Half page.
So obviously whoever writes for that listens to the show.
Very nice. Who wrote this? Doesn't say, there's no byline.
You can pick those up at like New Fine Arts,
mm-hmm.
Amazing Bars. Superstores, places like that.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Oriental women.
Ooh, cocky.
Damn, those crazy Japs will do anything. Stick a funnel down their throat, they're good to go.
God.
You ever seen the website?
No. What are you talking about? A funnel down their throat?
You've never seen that?
No. What are you?
Am I the only one?
Don't talk about this. I've seen it, and I when those pop up, I get away from them as quick as I can.
Crazy Oriental bitches.
I don't even want to know.
It's so you don't miss.
And it's a bunch of guys.
Later. Oh, okay. Now I get it.
She liked it. They got a funnel right here.
Okay.
And everybody around going,
oh.
A lot of them.
Why?
I don't know that she's a crazy Japanese bitch.
She don't want to miss nothing.
They're very thankful. They don't like to waste. Actual photo. Petite, sexy, blonde, the one of your dreams. All kind of women in the back of this. Phone numbers, too.
I was going to ask everybody, how did they get away with that?
They're probably lonely.
How did they get away with that?
Sometimes they don't. I mean, some of those are actually called by Vice, who ultimately arrest them.
For what?
For prostitution. You may be surprised by this, but some of those women are actually prostitutes.
These aren't just lonely chicks that put their pictures in the paper?
No, some of them are actually selling their bodies for money.
I mean, they have hourly rates listed there.
Yeah, Sarah, discreet in call. What does that mean?
That means she'll...
I'm sorry.
That means you go there, I think. Then out calls when they come to you.
Correct.
And in calls when you go there.
All right. Discreet in call. Prompt out call. 2 girl shows. Credit card cash. 24/7 by appointment only. $125.
For an hour?
It says $125 total independent price. Female help wanted. Nympho Nancy. Come and get it.
Why wouldn't Vice just go through that ever and just go flip every one of them?
Well, they do randomly select them and do go through. They also play some of those ads.
Oh.
Oh, they do?
Yes.
Mm. Not too bad.
Hmm. Olivia, transsexual, actual photos.
Hey, Dan.
Mercedes. Tropical Barbie.
Mm. Hey, there's a Latin transsexual.
I see right here. Simply beautiful and classy for the discreet clientele. I have sexy, natural, tan skin, long, curly hair.
It doesn't say that.
It says most of it.
But if you look long enough, you could probably find what you just said.
Yeah.
God, how particularized does your fetish have to be? I want a Latin transsexual Jewish amputee.
With a penis. God, they got a bunch of transsexuals.
Yeah, you're in the transsexual section.
Yeah, you're right. I didn't realize that. Well, that explains all the ugly chicks. Swing with hot locals. Casual sex, first 30 minutes are free. Buy curious locals. Let's call that one.
You see JD nervously shuffle around over here and take a drink?
Shut up.
Kill you.
I wonder why they say actual photos.
As opposed to this is just a model similar. This is the real girl that will show up.
Oh.
So that Mavis doesn't come over to your house.
Do what, Dan?
This is me. They want you to know that that's the girl you're getting.
All right.
But do you really want a girl that you've just picked out of the back of a magazine to have your credit card number?
I want this guy with his hands in his pants.
Yeah, you get everything. That's available, too. There's men and women, couples that'll show up and do...
Really?
Everything.
They'll just come to your house?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, how does that work, JD?
Wait, you pay them?
The magazine.
You pay them to come to your house and have sex in front of you?
Some people do. It's just part of that magazine. I've looked through that magazine many times. I used to deliver it every week to the old station. Don't look at me like you're flipping through it right now.
We're all looking at you, JD.
What does it cost to come in?
No clue. Never called one.
Sabrina, the Canadian Black Beauty.
Oh, I know what she costs.
She only takes cash.
Yeah.
Bitch. There's a transsexuals again. I like Lindsay. She's cute. You see her? She's right there.
She can't spell her name.
She can't spell her name.
You know why? It says Lindsay without the D. And then underneath it, it says young, dumb, and looking for fun.
The D's already in her.
Eddie actually got up to go across the room and smack his mic. Shanona looks good, too. That's what it says. Okay, I'm done with that. Eddie? Let's see what this chick wants. By the way, did I tell you? I don't know if I made this clear on the air yesterday or not. No more topless chicks in this room.
Absolutely.
After yesterday of having to negotiate... They can come and they can go to the appearances because they're hot and I like to look at them, but I'm not going to have them come in the studio and negotiate to get their cans out.
Absolutely. Understand.
Did you talk to the salespeople?
I don't talk to the salespeople anymore. I've been told not to. I can't talk to them at all.
But do they know why nobody else can come in?
Yes.
You missed it yesterday, Everett.
What happened?
Oh, we were going to have some come in to audition for Happy the Clown.
Okay.
We didn't have a script, so it's like, you know, talk, show me your cans, and then, you know, we'll call you later.
Sure.
I don't want to. You got to come to the club.
So they're trying out for a part in which their cans are critical.
Right.
So they're actually getting the part, and they refuse to show their cans.
Absolutely. Both chicks.
You're kidding me.
Both of them. You got to come to the club. All right, well then, you know, thanks for coming. See you.
They were trying to be coy and cute, and it didn't fly. So they've ruined it for everyone else.
You're really kicking me out because I won't pull these out? Why do you think you're here? There are two reasons why you're here, and they're below your neck.
Why is it random chicks off the street are far more likely to whip their cans out than...
I don't know.
know. I guess because they're used to getting, you know, cash every time that they come out. Will I get paid for that? What do you think I just gave you in radio for coming into this studio?
Sure. They come up here, market themselves, say their stage name. Everybody right. talks about how beautiful they are. And
what time they're on.
Right. They were both hot, but no cans. It's like that dope, who was a hypnotist that came in the studio and didn't want to hypnotize anybody?
Flip Orley.
Flip Orley comes in. We bring people in for him to hypnotize. He's performing that weekend at the Improv. I go, okay, we got the people. You ready to, No, I don't want to do that. Really? No, I don't like that.
I was going to come in and tell some jokes.
You're a hypnotist and you want to come in and you don't want to do any hypnosis. Okay. So we kicked him out.
You're really throwing me out?
Yeah, he couldn't believe we were kicking him out. You're a hypnotist, and you're not going to do anything. Nobody really gives a rat's ass about your personal life or your likes and dislikes. Hypnotize or get lost.
Make people think they're chickens. Make guys dance around like a ballerina. Then get out.
I still think the whole hypnosis stuff is a crock.
I've actually seen him twice. He's really good.
We don't like him.
I mean, he sucked.
Thank you. I think people just get on stage and go along with it, and after a while, he starts buying his own hype. Press. Yeah, his own hype.
If we liked him, I'd say he made my mouth get really dry when I was in the audience, but he said, you're right, fraud.
We didn't go that far, Everett. Just you did.
Do I?
We didn't go that far, Everett.
Yeah.
We just
said
we didn't like him.
Yeah.
That's just my opinion.
Hold on.
Oh.
Danny, what is, can I call you Danny? You all right with that? So I can discern back between, you and Dan?
Yeah, that's fine.
All right. Are you pick. You want Danny or what's your last name?
O'Malley.
Which one do you want?
O'Malley.
Oh, God.
I haven't been called Danny since I was like two.
Does anybody else call you O'Malley?
No.
You want to use your middle name?
Tobias?
I guess not.
Oh, God. I curse you.
All right, we'll just call you O'Malley.
All right.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
What does McNeil want?
He didn't say. He said he just needed to talk to you.
Well, if you're going to be a good call screener, you're going to have to check and see what he wants.
Well, he's still the boss, so want me to ask him real quick?
Yes, leave your mic on so I can hear.
All right.
Dan, you need to straighten him out on.
Bobby, there.
Oh. What does this name go?
Damn.
He says he's your boss and he has to talk to you.
I understand that. Ask him what's it about.
He wants to know what's it about. He said it's about his big dumbass producer, Dan.
What about him?
What about him?
See, I've never gotten to hear it from this side.
It's funny.
Yeah.
What did he say?
He said he needs to talk to you.
All right. This one time.
He wants you bad. Okay, hang on.
All right. Yes, Bob?
I can't believe you did that to another phone screen.
Bob, I mean, you know, the show's going on here. It's just
Here's the problem with the strippers, okay?
Okay.
If your big, dumb-ass producer, Dan, didn't screw around and go around me and go directly to the clients, we'd have this all sorted out because we'd have all of them understanding before they go in there what's expected of them and this wouldn't happen. But he's the problem. He keeps going to the clients, going to them directly, and then we lose control.
Did you do that, big dumbass?
I didn't go to the client. I did. I made a mistake. I forgot. I talked to the AE. I talked
to. How many times?
Well, hold on. Wait a minute. First of all, the fact that Dan went straight to the account executive over this topless bar—that's got no bearing on how this played out.
Oh, yes, it does.
No, they all know. You come into the studio, you pop out the cans. You're a topless dancer. You're not here for your law degree.
Yeah, but I get to reiterate that before they go in there with the manager so they understand the parameters.
Did you tell them any of that, Dan?
Yes, I did. And the salesperson told them ahead of time, when you go in, when he says pop them out, don't argue. And then she left. She had to go back to work. She went back upstairs.
All right, so they were warned ahead of time.
Yes.
Everybody knows.
Right. And they didn't.
Still, it's just not the way we're supposed to do it.
I understand that. All right, so Dan screwed that up, but that's got nothing to do with the way this played out.
Well, I'm not so sure.
What else should have been done?
Well, nothing, but at least I would have been involved, and I would be sure that everybody understood what I knew that they needed to know. And at this point, although I have Dan's assurance that, you know, he told everybody what they needed to do, I also have Dan's assurance that he isn't going to go directly to the clients again.
Did you go directly to the client?
I didn't go directly to the client. I went to the salesperson. We were emailing back and forth about people coming up for the pool party thing tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And I just added that in. I said, oh, by the way, Russ is looking for love interest for, you know, auditions for the movie. Ask them if they'd be willing to come up.
A very, very innocent mistake.
I see. Let's not have any more innocent mistakes, please.
Shouldn't you be busy programming your new weekend shows?
I've already programmed the weekend shows.
Is it already done?
They're all ready to go.
And when does this fabulous new music programming start?
It starts at 10 a.m. on Saturday.
Really? And what is the first show that's on?
Beatles Brunch. What?
I didn't say anything.
It's a Beatles brunch for 2 hours, and then from noon to 6 on Saturday and noon to 7 on Sunday, we do a rock and rock weekend.
You are not.
What?
You're doing Beatles for brunch?
Yes, on Saturday.
And then rock and rock? What's the other thing called?
Rock and rock weekend.
Whose idea was this?
Mine.
And you're going to play what?
We're going to play classic rock and some new rock.
And you're going to call it rock and rock?
Rock and rock weekend. Sort of play on rock and roll, but it's not rock and roll, it's rock and rock.
Why don't you just call it a rock weekend?
Well, because there's two different kinds of rock. We're playing some older rock and today's rock together. Nobody does that.
There's probably a reason for that.
Yeah, but nobody
does. You are really not going to do Beatles for brunch.
For 2 hours, yes, on Saturday morning.
Saturday and Sunday?
No, Saturday only.
And what happens Sunday?
Sunday is just the same thing we're doing Saturday afternoon, rock and rock.
Rock and rock.
Rock and rock.
Is this every weekend or just this one?
Every weekend.
Oh, okay.
Well, actually, we're going to try the rock and rock this weekend, see how it does, and if the response is good, we'll go with that, or, you know, we'll try some other themes, maybe.
Oh, I think the Beatles for brunch, I think that's I'm genius.
You're loving that, aren't you?
Genius. I hate the Beatles.
I know that.
I can't stand the Beatles.
But a lot of people like them.
Why not Loverboy for lunch?
Well, there's not enough songs for an entire lunch. I mean,
yeah, you can. Supertramp for supper.
Yeah. We'll take the long way home. Okay.
Bad finger at bedtime.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You like the way JD acts like he doesn't know what's going on?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I already know that you were talking to Bob.
About what?
About this weekend thing.
Yeah. He asked me a couple things.
And what else?
He asked me about music from the when I was the music director at the Eagle for some ideas.
Mm. Oh, what about doing a weekend show?
It's not a weekend show.
Can I have the audio, please, Dan?
Here you go.
You bastard, Bill. Bob. What's your name?
Bob.
Is this the one? Is that it? We got too many mini discs in here. Lucky for you, I don't know which one you're on.
Good.
You think it's this one?
Why would I ever trust you ever, Bob? Why?
Bob said you were screwing around. You were going to lie to me about something.
I'm not going to lie to you.
Wait a minute. You said you were going to try to slide this one by.
No.
What does that mean?
Was,
if I find this on the tape.
As far as it's an appearance, it'll be one thing. If it was a show, because I know how you got when Dan started talking about doing a weekend show. You got
And you were saying that you could sell it to him as an appearance, but it would really be a show.
Well, as long as I'm on a remote, it would be an appearance. But from the studio, from the studio, I didn't want to do it, didn't I?
I don't think you said that.
I think so. Well, we'll just find out.
I guess I'll just play it in.
I've been looking forward to doing
a
James Bond movie.
See, that's what I wanted to do. James Bond movie.
Shut up. It's the wrong track.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Same as always. Big.
Which one is Bob?
Track Goose Egg.
Well, I could use a driver.
He's the one that sounds like Clint Eastwood. I'm Jeff Daniels.
How come nobody ever labels stuff when they put it in here?
Because I normally hand you mine.
Get those out of here, Eddie. Got too many damn mini discs floating around.
So we won't be using audio today?
We already used audio.
We didn't use the other audio.
We'll see how you turned on your buddy.
I didn't turn on you.
I was trying to slip it past him.
I didn't say that.
Hey, Russ. Good morning.
All right, that's Rob. Where is it? Oh, it's not on this one. You're screwing with me now. You're handing me the same mini disc over and over.
Thank you, Eddie.
There's nothing on this one. You get the gorgeous red intuition. Shoot yourself. What is this?
These are the ones you already played.
It's the one that says Bob and JD. You want to fess up to anything before we play?
I already said what I said.
Well,
which is you got all up bent out of shape when Dan talked about doing a weekend show.
I wanted Dan to do a weekend show.
Didn't.
Yes, I did. Just so he could see what it's like to stand here in the middle and have stuff crap around you.
I know what it's like. I don't want to do it.
Like this.
And I told that to him.
Yeah.
I don't want to do it.
And my name's all over this crap. I'm sitting right in the middle of the toilet. Nothing's working.
I've done that.
What do you mean like this?
Would you just give the right disc?
Yeah, Dan, step in the middle of it. God.
So, man. I just want to talk to you for a minute, because I'm doing some music stuff.
Is it long?
It's very long.
Oh. How long before he sails me down the river?
I just told you down the river.
About 4 or 5 minutes into it.
All right. I'll fast forward during the break. Anything you would admit before we get to it?
I'll tell you exactly what I said, which is you got weird when Dan wanted to do a show. So I said, how about it? He said, well, we're going to sell remotes to the clients. And I said, remote's different. That's an appearance. But I don't want to sit in here and do a music show. I don't want to do it.
I can't wait for you to hear the tape, but that has nothing to do with what you said.
You are so wrong.
That's not even close.
I'm not going to help you with your damn music either now.
Well, he didn't want any help. This was a host job to start with. Like, what do you know? You can't even recognize songs when we do that damn contest.
Music director, the contest is mini disc, whatever crap.
So, I recognize it. Yeah. Everett gets it.
Good for you. I played the real songs on the radio. I didn't play some.
You didn't play nothing.
Disc.
You took money for trips.
Yeah, that's what I did. That's what I did. You're right. That's right.
All right. Thanks, Bob.
All right.
I won't go around you anymore, Bob. Not with any of the salespeople.
Hey, what about all this? Paid,
I will.
What about all this paid programming on the weekend?
Gone.
Is it really?
Gone.
What about Al Carroll?
Bye.
He's not going to be on Saturday mornings anymore?
Hmm. No.
What about the golf show?
Golf show, yeah.
Well, that's
Dave. Oh, but
more of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
You do a legal ID, Eddie?
I did not.
All right. 555, this is KYNG, Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas. Eddie Boyd is here, producer Dan Lewis. Everett Newton, J.D. Ryan, Jonathan Dodge is in the thing. Nothing you want to fess up to till before I play this?
Nope. I told you what I said.
Yeah, whatever. You say a lot of stuff.
Okay. Why was you don't trust me? It'd be set up, so, you know.
Well, the idea was Bob was going to ask you to do a weekend show, and you were going to wig out and say, no, I got enough stuff to do. And Bob calls me.
Basically, they say I didn't want to do a weekend show from in here. They talked about doing remotes. He goes, that would be a great sales tool. Well, then I could do appearances. I do appearances. But I'm not going to sit around and DJ a show. Then he goes, well, maybe voice tracks. Well, I could do that.
Why not? Works so well for Clear Channel.
Mm-hmm. It's his idea.
And you kind of listen. And I don't know how much credibility I'm going to have. I'm just going to be a boring number, I guess.
I think a lot.
What are you guys talking about right here?
Just the
credibility.
Just back month, he said, well, you know, because you were at the Eagle. I went, that was 15 years ago. I don't know how much credibility I'm going to have. I go, well, I think a lot.
I don't remember those days. So. And I was there. But, I mean, that's as long as he understands.
You don't remember those days because you was all cranked up.
I was never cranked up. I was married with two kids.
And all cranked up.
I didn't even drink back then.
You didn't have to. You know why?
Why? Yeah. No, I wasn't cranked up. Never did drugs.
We called you the train.
Did not.
He's always on toot.
You know better.
That's not any kind of conflict with what we're doing, and it's more of an appearance thing as opposed to,
Have I missed where he,
No, it's still coming up.
Okay. Yeah, I guess that more of an appearance thing than a JD doing a show.
Yeah, hush. You don't get to talk when you're on trial.
That's part of our plan. That's part of how we recover the money that we're losing from the shows that were sold. Is that now we have the flexibility of going out and selling remotes, which we just...
Thank you. Going out and selling remotes. Now we have the flexibility to go out and sell remotes.
Excuse me?
I'm just telling you what he said.
He hasn't asked about Russ yet.
What about Russ?
I don't know. How about if you let me hear the tape and stop interrupting it?
I'm just trying to say what was said.
I know what was said. I heard it.
Okay.
He waved money in your face and do anything.
For appearances, yeah. They pay pretty well. And I don't have, you know, the money to go out and buy mini Batmobiles like some people do. I need the cash.
Maybe if you focused more on your career instead of trying to make money on the side, you get further.
Oh. So you don't trust me, you set me up, and then you're going to insult me.
Yes.
Okay.
You were supposed to go in and go, no, I got enough stuff to do. I want to focus on the show that's paying my bills.
Well, he's talking about on the weekends.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I guess you're happy with the job that you're doing.
Well, if you're not, get rid of me. You got a new co-host in here anyway. That's all right. Dan's the new guy. I'm folding up. Are you Daniel read the news?
Maybe I'm the new guy. I've been here 4.5 years.
He's been here longer than you have.
That's fine. I'm just saying. Just let Dan do it all.
I don't think JD likes you being in this studio.
No, I don't mind him being in here. Just whatever.
Well, where did
if
that come from?
If you don't like that I'm doing the job I'm doing, I will leave.
You don't see Dan taking on another job. Because he knows he's not doing a good job on the way he's doing now.
On the way.
Hey, wait a minute.
Hey. I need a valve.
I can only handle one of you guys this time.
All right.
It's like y'all are fighting to get in the barrel.
Move.
In the middle of the home show. First of all, we'll work.
Yeah.
We're at Home Depot, and we're playing music. Just because the data tracks people or anywhere, whereas the guy talking about costing
the remote in the middle of the
show. How long before he sells me out?
Just the next couple of minutes. It goes on for a while. It's like the entire thing's like 9 minutes long.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Why didn't anybody edit this down? All right, before I get that far, is it worth listening to?
It's the actual part is very brief when it gets to him asking about, well, how do we get Russ involved in this?
Who asked that, Bob or JD?
Bob. No. And how can we get Russ involved and out to these things?
Never asked that.
Yeah. And it gets down to... JD, I can't remember exactly what he said now.
He never asked about getting you out anywhere. He knows better.
Does F. Russ ever come up in this?
No, no. He never gets nasty or rude. He just says that we'll lie to you and tell you it's either a remote and not an appearance, and that'll get you out
it
there.
It is. No, not. It will get him out there. I never expected him to come out there.
That's what it sounded like to me.
Oh, okay. Play it then, please.
I may have just misinterpreted.
It's not talking to the same. And I think our audience is a rock music audience. And so on the weekends, it makes all the sense to them that we play some kind of rock music.
Should start on Saturday and Sunday alone?
No, nope. Saturday is...
Beatles for breakfast or brunch.
He's just explaining the format. Yeah, that's... Same guy that...
Why didn't you tell him the whole idea sucked?
Well, but be honest, playing music on the weekends better than the crap we had. Honestly. What I was telling him is we're on remote and you can't even play our own radio station at remotes because nobody wants to hear that crap.
The Stones, the theme weekends, yeah, like that, but... We do want to keep current music
in. Bob was trying to really suck him in on this, so he spent a lot of time talking about the music.
Yeah, that's what I told him. I went, don't just immediately come out and go, all right, we want you to work 7 hours every Saturday.
It's going to be obvious, but there'll be a few.
Did I just hear my name?
We do want to keep current music in. I think that.
I just like to say this is a great bit, and it better not end up on Best Of.
Oh, it's yeah.
Well, that's something that would be very interesting to do. And it's different. Nobody else has done it. So, unless we do that too. Seems really, there's lots that's going to be obvious, but there'll be a few that are going to be real specialty stuff in this market. But, I don't have any that were left over in this
Russ would be good, too, at helping him pick out music.
Oh.
Because you and I both worked at the Eagle during the heydays.
I didn't pay attention to what the hell we were playing.
Yes, you did.
I have no idea what we played back in 87.
How do you know all the songs, then?
Okay.
How do you know his wife?
I'll put together a little bit around and we'll...
Wait a minute.
Evidently, we passed it.
It's pretty soon, quick possible. Yeah, don't worry about it. This one, this weekend, we'll be right through what we're doing. But,
give it to me. I'll listen to the whole thing and I'll find the...
Just give me the thing, because I can't stand this anymore.
I'll find exactly where it is.
So far, what I told you, I said. I never volunteered you for anything. You won't leave the house.
I don't think that's... I think the way it was described was you were figuring out how you were going to get me to go along with this. Not go out on appearances.
What I said is he wigged out when he thought Dan was going to do a weekend show, and I don't want that. Furthermore, I don't want to do a weekend show in the studio. Doesn't that?
Russ didn't wig out.
Well...
Well, what he wigged out on was... What brought it up was, Russ got irritated with me and says, you think this job is so easy? Go out and get your own show.
I wanted Dan to have his own show so he would appreciate what I do, unlike you.
I do appreciate what you do.
No, you don't?
I say that all the time. First of all, I've done what you do, and it sucks. It's hard. It's impossible. A music show is bad enough, and I don't want to sit in here on the weekends and play music. Then he went, well, how about tracks? Well, yeah, you want to use my voice? That's your business. You own it. But as far as remotes, that becomes an appearance.
I'll go find it right now.
Please do.
Backstabber.
I'm not.
Wasn't bad enough. You punched me in the chest 12 years ago. Now you're stabbing me in the back.
And that
still hurts, by the way.
It doesn't hurt. Right here. That's your waist. Didn't stab you in the back. And I think the idea to play music on the weekend is a great one. I'm surprised that they approved it. More likely to get people to listen to this radio station on the weekends out by pools and places, parties and pools.
It fits more with what's going on.
Exactly.
But the Beatles, Jesus Christ, come up with something a little more imaginative.
I'm with you on that.
And why label it? Just play stuff. Why you always got to label crap? Just play it. Let people decide what the hell it's called.
I wouldn't go into the 60s. At all, music-wise.
No.
You got K-Love for that.
No, no.
Should be 80s and 90s. Maybe a couple tracks from the 70s.
I'd play some really good stuff from the 70s.
Eagles had a bunch of great stuff. Foreigner had a bunch of good stuff.
I'd listen to that.
Yeah.
And you know what he's trying to do? We'll play some classic rock with some new rock.
Yeah.
Let me think. Q102.
Yeah. Gone.
They tried it. It didn't work. It worked for a while. Music just got too weird.
There's a lot of music. As I told him somewhere in that tape, there's a bunch of stuff. If you just picked the top 20 and went for 15 years.
What tape are you talking about?
During that, somewhere along that line, he was talking about the format. Because he asked me to come up with a list of stuff. I'm glad I spent 2 hours on the computer last night looking at music for you, Bob.
No, I think he still wants it. He asked me for a list of stuff. I'm not going to do it.
Mm-mm.
Or I'll give him a bunch of disco.
Well, there's a few songs that were... They were bigger here than they were other places. Y&T, Summertime Girls was one of them. You use it as a bumper.
Yeah. Nobody knew that outside the market.
Some of the poison stuff.
We have to break before news?
Please.
But the Beatles, Jesus.
Yeah. Well, I'd be like doing a set of the Stones. I couldn't stand that. I can listen to the Beatles before I can listen to the Stones.
I've never understood those triple shot anything. Because as soon as they go, hey, we got a triple shot of the Stones coming up, if I don't like the Stones, I'm out for 10, 15 minutes. This clumping stuff together.
You must like the Beatles.
It's a rock block of the Who. I hate the Who, so I'm gone for 15 minutes.
See ya.
And I'm not going to suffer through a bunch of Who songs to see what my next rock block is.
Then you're locked into something else. By the time the Who's over, you've forgotten about that station. You don't go back.
It's a waste of time. Specialty shows. Meatloaf at Midnight.
I kind of like that one.
Well, what do you got? You got Paradise by the Dashboard Lights, Two Out of Three Ain't Bad, and Bat Out of Hell. Or is that the name of the album?
That's the name of the album.
Two songs.
Yeah.
You watch. He's going to start doing deep cuts and a bunch of other retarded stuff.
Beatles. Two words for Bob. Superstar country.
Yeah, that was his idea, wasn't
it? Yeah, it was.
And that crapped the bed pretty quick. Look how he had on the ear, though.
Ooh.
All right, we're going to take a break here.
of the Russ Martin Show, coming right up.
Dan found the segment. You sure you don't want to fess up?
No, I'm telling you what I said.
Okay.
I reviewed the conversation in my head, and I can't think of anything I said that was the least bit dishonorable to you or the show. Mm-hmm. My recollection was he said, do you want to do a weekend show? And I said, no. It wigged Russ out before, so no. Now, and he goes, well, we could use it as a sales tool, as you heard him say that, and you can go remotes. Remote is not a show in the studio.
How long would the remote be?
A couple hours. Any like any other appearance?
Okay.
I don't know what to do as far as the
All right, I don't know what JD's saying. What did he say? Is that where he said, let's stab Russ in the back? That's what it sounds like.
It's about to start. Bob is trying to ask him the question, how do we get Russ involved?
What is it with Bob and mic placement? He has screwed up more bits. The bit with Reed, where we told, where Rob and Bob went to Reed, the general manager, and said, Eddie beat Rob up. Because Rob got his ass beat one weekend down in Deep Ellum. Mm-hmm. So he had black eyes and stuff. We figured Reed would buy it. Rob actually breaks down in front of Reed and cries. Bob, don't get that one.
No.
You think somebody in radio would know how to place a mic or at least test it, play it back, see if that's going to work. JD could admit it to killing Kennedy. We wouldn't have been able to get it.
Well, this is the best he could do without. He had to hide the mic in his office, and his office is very sparse. There's not very many things to hide a mic in. There's no plants.
This is worse. This is like our own Zapruder tape.
So he stuck the mic underneath his desk.
His ass?
No, underneath the desk. And he thought by sitting on the other side of the desk would help.
All right, Bob isn't in charge of bits anymore.
He also forgets where he's going.
Who, Bob?
Yeah, as far as where to lead somebody down the garden path, he forgets. He gets actually involved in a real conversation.
Yeah, that's what it sounded like it turned into. Hey, you know what? Even though this is a host job, JD could really help with this. Then I get a call from Bob. Bad news. He wants to do it. The whole idea is for you to go, I'm not going to do a six-hour shift on the weekends.
You never said 6 hours.
That's because he's adult.
Oh.
You're right. Well, Superstar Country. It was a big genius programming as far as country music goes. Well, young country's not working. We'll call it Superstar Country. We'll play the same yak.
And the same jocks.
We'll call it something different. Yeah, same jocks, same everything. We'll just change the name. People won't notice. Mm-hmm. I know. We'll hang a sign out in front of the radio station under new management. We're not F-ups anymore. I always wonder why people did that under new management. Yeah. Why don't you just hang a banner up and go, hey, the idiots are gone.
Come back, try us again.
We know before we were F-ups. We're better now.
I wonder what the best way to approach Russ on it would be. We can do.
Nobody move.
Make it sound like it's an appearance.
Aha! Aha!
Make it sound like it's an appearance.
That's what I said. Make it sound.
When he approaches
you. Why not just say,
why
not just say, it's appearances. Why not make it sound? That's deceptive.
That's right. Deceptive. That's the only thing you can find out of a 9-minute conversation. Just throw me to the wall.
Make it
when
sound.
When you bring it to him.
But isn't that a deception? Make one thing sound like something else is a deception.
Guys, you want me to lay down so all of you can get on top at once?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there enough room?
No.
Oh, yeah. Make it sound.
When they approach you with it, which they'll have to do, which I said here, it's got to go through us, and when it does, make it sound like it's just appearances, which is what it is. It's not
make
a show.
It sound.
No, I told
make
them
it sound.
I'm not.
Why would you have to make it sound?
Because I don't want Bob to go to JD's going to do a weekend, because he approached me with the idea of a weekend show, and I don't like the way that sounds. Because I remember the way you and Dan had, get Dan his own show. I don't want my own show. I've had my own show.
He asked you, what's the best way to connect Russ on this?
To make it sound. Not to connect Russ on it. Not to bring Russ in.
Damn.
I didn't stab you. Bring it up to Russ. Now bring him in on it. If that's what Bob was supposed to say, that's not what he said.
Bob's not. I'm going to have to start writing Bob's crap out.
Get him a teleprompter next time you want to burn me.
Reed will not talk to anybody in his office anymore.
He's smart. I just keep forgetting whatever this place is. I trust people.
I know.
That's why I keep falling for these stupid...
Let's make it sound.
I'm not ashamed of this statement.
Make it sound. I'll wait till Russ turns around.
No.
When he's not looking. And then you know when he gets you. Stab him right in the puss.
I don't know what to do as far as the rush field cut the 90s down.
Here.
I wonder what the best way to approach Russ on it would be. We can be okay. Make it sound like it's...
Backstabbing bastard.
Quit it. You're laying over and over and over and stopping it there. Let me hear what I say. I don't even remember what I said.
It doesn't matter what you say.
It does matter.
Make it sound.
As to approach you, don't be stupid and don't go, JD's going to do a weekend show. Say, it's appearances. It's a weekend show. It's appearances. Make it sound that way. Don't make it sound. It's the way he presents something. I don't want him to, Bob, to come in and go, I want JD to do his own show.
Here's how we play it to Russ.
He asked how to approach you on it.
Make it sound.
Yes.
I don't even have to hear what the rest of it is.
Yeah, well, then if I'm not convicted on that, then fine.
Damning.
It's not damning. You got to play all the evidence.
Okay.
Go ahead. Quit rolling it back. Because you're going to stop it again after making sound.
Yeah.
Make it sound.
I wonder what the best way to approach Russ on it would be.
Weekend deal? Make it sound like it's...
Please let it roll. I don't even remember what I said.
That appearance is instead of a music show. Sometimes we kind of do my own show. Maybe it's just appearances that you kind of let them... And I don't know how much credibility I'm going to have.
That's where you picked it up before. That's all it is. I don't know how much credibility I have doing it.
I guess I'm going to have to get a hat with rearview mirrors.
I didn't do anything.
Eddie, make me a hat with blind spot mirrors on it. Would you please?
I didn't do anything. I don't think that sounds guilty at all. He asked how to approach you on it, and I said, make it sound like it's appearances, which is what it would be.
Well, why didn't you just say, tell him it's appearances?
I'd make it sound. Well, maybe my phrasing was wrong, but that's what I meant.
Oh, you just pulled a chick.
Tell him.
You just pulled a chick.
That's what I meant.
John.
I'm dead.
I know what I said, but here's what I meant.
I'm dancing here.
So you going to do it?
What? It's not anymore. I wouldn't spit on Bob if he's on fire.
Hey, that's a good bit.
Set Bob on fire?
Yeah, see who spits on him. I mean, it's a lot of whiz.
Yeah.
I've been waiting for this. Hey, what are you doing to Bob? He's on fire. Hold on a second. Hey, it's going to take a while, Bob.
I have to smother it.
Now, what I was thinking is what he said to replace some of the revenue they're losing.
Stop dropping crap. What?
That they'd sell more remotes on the weekends.
They would.
Okay, that's all I was saying. They go to like the Guitar Center or places like that, and there would be an opportunity for remotes, not a show.
Bob screwed the whole thing.
Like I'd sit in there for 6 hours and play music.
Bob screwed the damn thing up. He was supposed to tell you, I want you to do 6 hours in your contract. I can tell you when to work. He's supposed to go, I want you here Saturdays, at least for the first couple of months, working noon to six.
I never do that.
That's what he was supposed to do. He made this sound too easy.
Mm-hmm.
Then I get this call from him. Bad news. JD wants to do it.
Not what was said.
That's all right.
Sorry.
Make it sound. You got your news ready?
I suppose. Here, Dan, you want to read it?
What do you want Dan to read? Why do you keep bringing Dan up?
Just because he's trying to steal your job.
Everybody's jumping on me. Just leave.
No.
Dan didn't have anything to do with this.
I know. You don't trust me. You set me up.
Just because I don't trust you doesn't mean I don't.
So you admitted it.
Yeah. I trust you with, like, stuff in my house. Like, if I was going to go on vacation, I'd leave you with the keys.
Yeah.
I'd lock up the cash.
But you think I'd stab you in the back? Up here.
Up here?
Uh-huh.
No.
That's what you just said.
Well, for money.
And you must have thought so.
For money, maybe.
I wouldn't stab you for money. I don't mind doing appearances. They pay very well for the time we spend in them. Okay. They pay very well.
All right.
I don't see anybody else turning them down either.
Dan, can you get them to turn them down? I don't want to go anywhere.
That's what I'm saying. You're the only one that turns them down.
I hate appearances.
I realize that.
Not because I don't want to hang out with people, but they want you to do the wind-up monkey with the vest thing on with the little symbols.
I know.
I'm not going to do it. I hate doing that. I hated that at the Eagle.
I know. They're better. Right,
we want you to go out there and we want to do this. Really? Do I get a vest? We're about the symbols.
They're better at this station than any other one I've been at, about letting you just kind of be there and meeting people and talk to them.
Yeah.
Because Chloe takes over really well.
You don't have to put on a show.
I still don't want to go.
Did a nice job at not Champs. Where were you?
We were Carson's. Carson's Palace.
They didn't make you do the monkey thing?
No. Had somebody up there to direct the contest. And we just sat back, and Dan and I sat and watched the show. I went up two or three times, said, welcome, good evening. Show women are coming up. Stand by. Welcome to Carson's.
All right. You didn't see my ex running around in there?
I did not.
Mm. Let me ask you off the air, because she was in a specific area.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't notice?
No.
No. Do you have another appearance there anytime soon?
I will be there next Monday. Okay. The next four Mondays. This time I'll look for you.
Yeah.
Why don't you come out? Just stay away from that area.
Nah. That's the one relationship that still bothers me. And that one was gone like 6 years ago.
But you dropped by and seen her before. Why don't you just come by?
I thought there was a chance that something was going to happen.
Maybe there is. Maybe there's some other guy in the picture when you dropped by a few months ago. Now he's gone.
No.
Come on by. At least you have a reason to be there other than just dropping by to see her. You'd be at the station there.
I suppose.
How old would the kid be now?
Huh?
How old would the kid be?
A couple of years. What?
Nothing. Just you with a child. I remember you having to call me up before.
I'll buy an SUV.
You had to call me. I'm forgetful too. You had to call me to walk you through changing a diaper.
Yeah, I know.
Better hurry. Summer's almost over.
Yeah.
I just mean you get the best prices on cars. Would you?
Yeah.
Nothing. All right. Let me see what's on. I'll take this really quick. Go ahead, Mark.
Yeah, Russ. Hmm? Whatever happened with the pointy hat?
We changed our mind on the pointy hats, and now they're ordering pimp hats.
Oh, when should you get those?
I don't know, soon. Okay. Go take a look at them. It's pimphats.com.
Pimp hats?
Pimp.
Great. I'll go look.
All right.
Thanks.
Did everybody pick out their pimp hat yet?
I have not.
I'm
still shopping.
Okay.
It's a tough decision. There's a lot of good ones. I was thinking about the purple fur. Purple
what did you pick, Eddie? You already picked one, didn't you?
Yeah, it was the zebra strap.
It was the one right next to the one I picked.
Right next to the one that you wanted.
The one that I picked looks like the one that Rudy wore in Fat Albert and the Cosby Kids.
Yeah.
Almost like an oversized cabbie hat, sort of.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember what the hell they call those things. It's a cab driver hat, but it's...
I know what they call them. Blank hats. 628. J.D. Ryan's on the new 105.3 FM Talk with News.
Thank you, Russ. An antique 38 caliber pistol accidentally discharged as it was being handled by Republican Representative Bob Barr during a reception in his honor. The bullet hit a glass door. No one was hurt. Georgia lobbyist Bruce Widener said that he had removed the magazine from the 1908 Colt, but did not clear the chamber before he handed the weapon to Barr. Nobody was in any danger, and they said, quote, we were handling it safely, except that it was loaded. Spokesman.
And it went off.
And it went off. And then to try to spin it, a spokesman said,
make it sound like.
Yeah. Make it sound like it's an appearance. The accident only underscores the importance of proven gun safety measures, especially when owning and handling antique firearms.
Idiots.
Yes. Okay, as our parents always told us, when Fluffy and Spot die, they go to a nice big farm with lots of balls of yarn and fetching sticks that an animal could want. But the real question is, what will happen to your cats and dogs when you die? Well, if you got the cash, you can give them a better life than they have now by sending them to Pet Estates in Melrose, New York. It's a 7-acre farm, basically, near Albany, where your pets can enjoy warm meals and comfy beds in their own furnished condos, as opposed to kennel cages, etc.
How much?
The cost is $7,300 per year for cats, unless you specify you want the upgrade, which to the two-room condo with a porch, that's $11,000 a year. And for even that price, that doesn't include a kitty massage at $35 for 45-minute sessions. Now, for dogs, the prices are $14,600.
They'll massage your pussy cat for how much?
$35 for 40 minutes.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. It's a lot better than you get at the Korean bathhouses.
For dogs, the prices are $14,600 or $21,400. And that doesn't include...
And I immediately shut his mic off because I know that's a good jumping out point. Yeah.
And that doesn't include $40 half-hour baths for your puppies. So about $15,000 a year after you're dead if you want them to live in luxury. 27-year-old woman in Japan decided...
Hey, text my dog in case something happens to me.
Well, I'll take her.
No, your dogs would eat mine.
No, they wouldn't.
Yes, they would.
No, my
your dogs are 40, 50 pounds. Yeah. They'd eat Abby.
They're sweet, though.
They Dan, you got a chihuahua. Would you take my dog?
Sure. You might want to create a living will for Abby.
Why don't you just take her when he dies, Dan? It'd be a lot simpler.
Yeah.
Well, I will, but you need to provide for her.
You can't feed my dog?
Sure I can.
Russ, I'll take your dog.
But if the situation should arise that, say, you and I go together,
dude,
we both die at the same time,
yeah,
then there needs to be some sort of living will to provide for your dog. You should make Everett the executor, though, so you can handle your will. And
I'd rather just take your dog.
Well, there's more to it than that, though.
I'll feed it.
I never get a dog. No, you don't want to pay. You don't want to feed my dog.
Sure, I'll feed your dog.
No, you don't.
Yeah, if Russ sets up a trust.
Take my dog every
time. I'll take your dog.
Thanks.
Okay. 27-year-old woman in Japan decided life was no longer worth living, and she tried a unique way to end it all. She just jumped out of the back of a speeding car. The good news is the impact didn't kill her. Her body was then careened off two other speeding cars. That did it. The driver, they were friends going to a resort. They just kept going. They didn't even know they'd hit her until they heard their police reports and came back and turned themselves into the police. Don't look at me. And finally, in South Africa, a gentleman... Well, we have some audio clips you want to use this time around. We haven't used them yet. So we probably lost the mini-disc.
The mini-disc is probably gone. Right, skip that.
All right. South Africa, a gentleman looking for any kind of work he could find was approached by a stranger on the street who offered to pay him in cash and food for some odd jobs around the house. Seemed like a good idea and went back to the stranger's house. When he got there, the guy was ordered to basically give it to the new boss's wife.
So this guy meets
a guy,
that wants to work.
Like a homeless guy.
All right, he goes, hey, come to my house.
Brings him
and
back.
He gets him home. He goes, now screw my wife.
Basically.
Okay.
Well, the wife was right there, ready to go.
Okay.
The job hunter, for some reason, said, no, I won't do this.
Maybe she was ugly.
Could be. Could be her fat. At that point, the boss punched this guy in the face, pulled down his pants, and made him finish by hand.
The guy did?
Yeah.
To the other guy?
The boss to the homeless guy, basically.
Yeah, I got
manually.
It.
Manually.
Yeah.
He put the job hunter, the homeless guy's finishing fluid in a jar, then let him go.
Right.
The cops have
filed. It's like catching lightning bugs.
Yeah. They don't know why the guy did this, and the cops have filed charges. They'll have him under arrest this week.
Maybe the guy was impotent, and he was just trying to get some sperm.
Yeah.
To get his wife pregnant.
Or DNA for something or other.
No telling what kind of diseases the guy's carrying around.
Yeah. Or maybe it's the lightning bug thing.
Could be. This Saturday, Dan Lewis will be out at Bell Bottoms in North Richland Hills from 10 until midnight, 8407 Grapevine Highway at Harwood.
Stop. Man, that was 4 years ago. Let that die, please.
I would like to thank all of you for coming out.
Guess not.
If you could please stand back. All three of you. Stand back. You're starting to want me. Thank you.
Bell Bottoms is a great party place on Saturday.
I'll be giving away prizes.
Get there early.
I'll be asking trivia. We have prizes for everyone. And everyone they know.
It's a Jamaican Independence Day party. You can register, by the way, if you want to go with us to Jamaica. You can register to win a trip, the all-inclusive trip with you and your buddies for the Russ Martin birthday show party.
We don't even know when we're going. How are you registering for a trip?
We know we're going to go. We just don't know where yet. So, where you're
registered. Rob thinks he's got the prize down another $100.
Wow.
Yeah.
It was good at whatever it was.
I think it was $865. Actually, hold on a second. This is not for sure, so...
Yeah.
I want to say the last price I saw, they're trying to piecemeal a bunch of stuff together. Mm-hmm. I want to say they got it down to almost $650.
Jesus.
All inclusive. It can still go back up to $800 or whatever, but that was the last email that I got that they're working on.
They'll sell that trip out before it ever goes on available.
I got almost 200 emails just waiting.
Wow.
That's one airplane.
Two. Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
And each one of those emails is probably two people.
Or more, or a group.
Yeah. All right. So there we go. Dan registered for the trip, and it's all going to be the pre-Jamaican Independence Day party at Bell Bottom, Saturday, 10 to midnight. I'm J.D. Ryan on the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up. And now, back to the Russ Martin Show. With J.D. Ryan, producer Dan Lewis, associate producer Eddie Boyd, rock and roll attorney Everett Newton, and Jonathan Dodge in the new 105.3 FM Talk White Lightning.
All right. What is that?
Oh, it's Klo printed out the picture of that he took of me with Shakira when she was here today.
Let me see. Damn!
Unfortunately, it's a really lousy picture. I look like a complete and total goob, but I was kind of geeking out while she was here.
I don't think that's the picture, Dad.
Well, no, I know I'm not an attractive man, but it's
good.
That's an especially bad picture. I've never tried to fool myself into thinking I was good.
She's a piece.
She's gorgeous.
She kind of looks like a cross between, like, Mariah Carey and somebody that doesn't look like Mariah Carey. When was she here?
This morning. She was standing in the hall at one point before they took the pictures, and she had a TV interview to do. Her makeup guy was here with her to do her makeup, and
yeah.
She was standing in the hall just toe to toe with me, looking up into my eyes while she was having her makeup done. She's gorgeous. She was offered to you. She sings. You said you didn't know who she was, and so you turned it down.
I don't know who she is. I still don't. I'm looking at the picture. I don't know who she is.
Here's her album. The album's called Laundry Service.
Damn.
That's her first American. Our first English language album.
Have you ever seen her, Everett?
Never have. She's beautiful, though.
Do you know who she is?
I have no idea.
I just have... My daughter was watching MTV.
This says featuring the number one hit. Is she that big?
Yeah.
Number one here or number one
here?
It says featuring the number one hit, Suerte, Objection, and Underneath Your Clothes.
It's cut number three on the album. It's called Whatever, Whatever. There, in the Spanish language version is on there too, Suerte.
So is she from Mexico?
Colombia.
I missed
the crowd outside was huge.
Here?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell me she was this hot?
I tried. You said, I don't know who she is, I don't care.
I don't know who she is.
And you said you didn't care.
You didn't say she was a piece of ass.
I tried to tell you, you wouldn't listen. In fact, you got smart-ass with me and said, she looks like a man. And you never even looked at the picture.
Well, book her anyway.
She's gone. She was in town for today only. If you'd have said yes, I could have gotten her in.
I didn't know who she was.
Hour.
What cut?
Cut number three is the hit. The radio,
this ain't it.
No, the radio edit has this first part edited out. This is just the regular store version. Hold on.
This is the mall version.
Hold on.
This is a Weird Al song.
No, it's not. Cut three.
No, it's not cut three. This is cut one.
No, cut three is the hit. Whatever.
I like this one now. I like the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a rock version of Hava Nagila.
It has the kind of a Colombian influence, yeah. What is the? There's a dance that goes.
I don't know, but I think a cartoon mouse does it.
Yeah.
Waterfall flashes so irresistible. She speak English?
Oh yeah, very well.
Mm. All right, cut three is the hit.
It is. What's it called again?
Whatever.
Okay.
Whenever.
Or whenever.
She smell good?
Yes.
Nice ass.
Just, incredible. She came in wearing these super skin-tight leather pants that were tied.
Why didn't you just book her and then stick her in my face and go turn
and
this down?
You screaming at me.
I'm not going to scream because you brought this up here. Look at that.
And she's been belly dancing since she was like 7 years old. And so when she does her videos, the way she moves is just incredible. That's when I first saw her. My daughter was watching MTV.
This song sucks.
And I was in my office, and I heard the song. She's got a great voice.
This song sucks, though.
Well, you just don't like this music. And she belly dances in the video for this song, and it's just but wearing those type of clothes. Which
this is Objections, the other hit. Where is that? Oh, that was number one. It says number one's one of the hits.
Mm-hmm.
I like the first one better. What else is on here? And Underneath Your Clothes, track two. Damn.
It's a ballad.
Is it?
Or ballad-like.
I don't like it. I like the first one. This is her own Call Me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's the first one that jumps up. Great at a bar mitzvah.
She has a really sweet little speaking voice too. She talks like this too. To the people.
Here it comes. I don't know what she's saying.
I heard something irresistible about it.
It's not her fault if she is so irresistible.
Every 20 seconds you repeat. What is it, Gary? Gary.
Yeah.
What is it?
I'd like to ask you a question.
Yeah?
I'd like to know if I can start my own marketing campaign since you might be a star. Get four or five guys came out today. Everywhere I've been going here lately, everybody's been saying, good, man, we love you. And I said, well, I got to give it all to Russ. And I'd like to know if I can get me some pictures and get them signed.
Sure, what do I care what you do?
But you just remember one thing. Game over.
It ain't over.
It's over.
No, it's not.
You said that you could whip me the other day. Well, let me tell you something.
Hey, if you get ugly to me, I'm not going. I'm not going then.
You're full of crap as a Christmas turkey.
You know what? Now you're ugly. I'm not going.
But hey, I tried to be nice to you.
I'm being nice to you. I didn't say nothing.
You called me a fag.
You are.
What'd you say? Hey, let me tell you, Russ. You better. Hey, can I ask Everett a question?
Yeah.
Everett, I would like to know, Everett, if you made him his last will and testament.
No, I don't think that's going to be necessary, Gary.
Plus, the ankle run if you get near it.
Let me tell you something, Mr. High-powered lawyer.
He's a high-powered.
Let me tell you something, Mr. Mouth.
What the hell did I do to you,
P-boy? I'll lay a flat down on you, too, if you give me a lamp.
Do it.
Do it. Do it.
All right. Here it comes. All right, Bill.
Hey, Russ.
You left out the number.
Russ.
Oh.
Russ.
Hey, it looks something like this.
Hey, Russ.
Well, what is it? You got to get wound up first.
I got something to tell you.
All right. Tell me.
Big.
Even though I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. You big fat pussy.
No.
Great big fat pussy. Great big fat pussy. See?
That's very nice.
Right.
Well,
there was a nasty one.
We got a break again? Do what?
I got to get these in before 7.
Are we behind?
Just those right there, yeah.
Oh.
Well, if she comes back in town to actually play a show, this was just the promotional tour. I'll get her.
I have a little pajama party with this little Shakira.
Mm-hmm. And then she does,
She's like Thomas Dolby. Do what?
Some of the songs are also on there in Spanish.
Yeah. All right, Eddie says we got a break really quick.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
All right. There's some guy that says he knew Shakira. Line is at 9. Go ahead, Ernie.
Hey, Russ. First of all, you are the Rosaya.
Thank you.
Second of all, you just missed on Major Puntang, buddy. You just did. I mean, I met this girl back in Mexico. My family hangs around with people that, you know, they're like the Hollywood of Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
And she came in there when she first started getting famous.
I thought she was from Colombia.
She is from Colombia. She may have played clubs in Mexico.
Besides being hot, she's freaking nice, man. She'll talk to you and everything. She's got a little thick accent. Oh, by the way, put the chicken song. You're talking to a Mexican. So,
he said put the chickens on.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I missed it. All right, go ahead.
Sorry, your accent was too thick. We couldn't understand you.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
All right. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Okay, chicken. Dude, I mean, this girl will talk to you nicely, man. And she is freaking hot. 5'4", really tiny, beautiful booty.
I mean, dude,
this is the kind of piece of ass you want. And you just missed it, bro.
I didn't know who she was.
Damn, I've been trying to call Archer and saying, damn, get him in there, get him in there.
Dan called me or emailed me. Now, what did you do? Because you were going to show, we were in the office, and you said, do you want Shakira?
I said, do you want Shakira? I don't know who that is.
I don't.
And I tried to explain it to you, and you started making fun of me. I tried to show you a picture, and you wouldn't even look at that. And you said, oh, she looks like a man.
No way.
And so, well, he never looked at the picture. If he had, he'd know. I even tried to get him to come back this afternoon, but it was too late. They're already booked out. They're doing TV interviews for the rest of the day.
So what do we get? We get Jethro from the Beverly Hillbillies.
Yeah. You have to get her in there next time, buddy. You have to.
She looks like a cross between Britney Spears and Mariah Carey. Would you say, sort of?
Yeah. Maybe a little Tori Amos thrown in. I'm not sure.
Unless Milano.
Yeah.
Did you look at the face?
Mm-hmm. Get that little heart-shaped face.
And she is
very sweet. She was nice to everybody here.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate, you know, they had to hustle her in and out of here so quick.
She did a bunch of photos?
Did a bunch of photos. She did a picture with me and with Reed. And then all
Reed? Doesn't know who she is. Thanks. I got to go, Ernie. Reed doesn't know who she is.
He didn't have a clue.
What did he get a picture for?
We were standing in the hall, and he said, I'm about to go and get my picture taken with her. Who is she? And I said, well, she's an up-and-coming star. Yeah, what she do? She sings. Said, okay. And he went in and grabbed her and said, pretend you like me. And they took the picture. She didn't understand what he was doing. This man is grabbing me, and someone's taking a picture.
Did she give you a free pocket fisherman? Now, do they play this one on Wild 100?
That one and Cut Three.
I don't like Cut Three. Is that the big hit?
Yeah.
The,
it's Cut Three.
Whenever, whenever?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's Whenever, Wherever. I got it wrong.
Oh, that, the beginning of that sounds kind of like a Quentin Tarantino thing or something.
I want to hear the Mexican version. I can't understand this one. It's in Spanish.
At least now you have an excuse.
Yeah. Better in Spanish.
Yeah.
Makes it more exotic. Yeah, I like it a lot better in Spanish.
Yeah.
Chicken
mix. Add something to the chicken mix, yeah.
I'm not doing that. Maybe they left the studio door open.
She did. She smelled so good.
Let me see that picture again. You should put that on your website.
I'm going to. I'm going to put the picture of Reed on that, too.
She's a little honey.
Yes, she is. She was very nice. She signed autographs the entire time she was here.
Did you see the picture of her? My ex that's working at Carson's.
Right.
Has hair like that.
Okay.
Okay?
Can't possibly miss her.
Right. And about that height.
Okay. I'll find her.
Okay.
She may have been at the front bar.
You weren't supposed to say that on the air.
Oh, sorry.
That's why we danced around it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's been hours.
For hours, yes.
Been in the barrel since then.
All right. You ready to do...
Yes, I am.
All right. What is this? What is it, Tim?
Yeah, you need to give that chicken remix to Wild 100.
Why? They don't play this one?
No, the chicken remix is much better than the original.
Oh. Okay.
All right, thank you.
You want to do the plugs over this? I don't know if I can do it with a straight face.
What's the name of the album? It is
Laundry Service.
Yeah. I like this. Can you give me a copy?
Sure.
I still like the first one, too. Yeah, I got to do the plugs.
Okay. To learn more about the Russ Martin Show, to email anyone on the show, to get in the studio audience, to make a donation to the Listener Foundation, or to get on the show's weekly email list, simply go to RussMartin.com. To be on the list, receive information on Russ's birthday trip to Jamaica. Send an email with your name and phone number to trip@RussMartin.com. To email us during the show and only during the show, send your messages to studio@RussMartin.com. Visit our news director's links and photo gallery at JohnDavidRyan.com. To find Eddie's fascinating and provocative website, go to EddieBoyd.com. My website is now online at danlewis.net. To contact Everett Newton at his law office, call him at 214-823-LAWS or go to dallasattorney.com. For information about the rest of the station, go to kyng.com.
All right. See you guys tomorrow.
See you.
Bye. Bye-bye.